Clemson rolls in one. That was very lopsided. This one figures to be a little bit more competitive. Wake Forest, NC State, look at the coaches. Coach Clawson and Coach Doran right there. Coach Doran's Wolfpack with their season debut. Lost the last six games of last season. Looking to get right out of the gates. Coach Clawson looking for a more favorable opponent. Not Clemson this week. That one coming up on our air, 8 p.m. on ACCN. Welcome into the huddle. I'm Jordan Cornette, your host, Eric McLean, Coach Mark Rick, and EJ Manuel. Halftime, just trying to keep up with what's going on here. Coach Sweeney, how could you not be pleased with all those weapons you got? Coach Clawson hoping to be pleased at the end of this one as his Wake Forest team heads to NC State in their season debut. Look at Coach Doran as well. An hour away from kickoff here on ACCN. Pretty good one here coming up as NC State's making their debut as they host Wake Forest right here on our air, 38 minutes away from kickoff. Dave Clawson, the head man for those Deacons, has reached a program record four straight bowl games, looking to make it his fifth. Look, we're 24 minutes away from kickoff. Wake at NC State. Sam Hartman, his 12th career start, started as a true freshman, 20 career touchdown passes, looking to add to that total tonight. 24 minutes from kickoff, Wake Forest, NC State, right here on ACCN. More huddle when we return. Welcome back into the huddle. 21 minutes away from kickoff, Wake at NC State, right here on ACCN. A look at Coach Dave Doran, 4-8 last season. He's taken his team to five straight bowl games from 2014 to 2018, but missed last year, looking to get back on track starting tonight. He caught up with our Katie George just a bit ago.
Dave, your team has had its fair share of adversity last year with the injuries, this year with COVID-19. Now that you're finally in this moment about to kick off in your first game, what will your message be to the guys in the locker room heading out?
You know, we've come through a lot together. I think all these teams out there have, and just the surreal aspect of finally being able to play a game, all the things that have brought us closer together as a team. I just told them I want the world to see how they are, you know, what they're all about, how much they love each other, how much they love playing, and let their play be visible for that for everyone watching.
Wake Forest obviously has a very unique offense. They like that long mesh point. Yep. For your defense, what are some of the keys going against that kind of offense tonight?
Well, we have to tackle well. There's a lot of timing, and you got to get off blocks, you know. They're going to throw it up 7 to 10 times a game, too, you know, and we got to be able to play good coverage, not get penalties, play the ball. But it's about getting them behind the chains more than anything. You know, they're a team that goes really fast, and those types of offenses want to get that first down to get the rhythm going. So we got to do a great job keeping them from being able to do that.
Thanks for the time. Best of luck.
All right, thank you. Go Pack.
All right, we're just moments away from kickoff. Wake Forest at NC State, and there's a look at your Wolfpack starting quarterback, Bailey Hockman. It's not going to be Devin Leary. Hockman gets the start. Some news being made. The huddle returns after this break.
We know what's in front of us. Our players are up for the challenge.
Hartman again, looking to throw. Watch the end zone. Touchdown.
This is a dynamic group offensively.
Over the middle, caught. Amazing. Breaks it down with one hand.
And here is Knight, and Bam is Bam.
Touchdown, NC State. Now watch me work.
Welcome back into the huddle. There is your starting quarterback for the Wolfpack. 8 minutes away from kickoff, Wake Forest at NC State right here on ACCN. Bailey, last year, Bailey Hockman threw one touchdown, four picks. Now, Devin Leary, maybe the expected starter, reports that he is healthy. They just elected to go with the lefty here, Bailey Hockman. So, Coach, a decision like this coming down, you know, very late, right before kickoff, what are we to make of this?
Well, it's late to us. Everybody was expecting Leary. And, you know, sometimes as a coach, if you know you're going to play someone else, why tell the whole world? Why give them some kind of hint that might help them? You know, when you play a right-hander compared to a left-hander, certain times you'll bring a certain rush to flush a guy away from his throwing side. So they might have had some blitzes designed for a right-hander, and all of a sudden they got a left-hander. But Bailey Hockman is a kid out of Powder Springs, Georgia. He played in McEachern High School for his dad, one of the best programs in Georgia. He'll be ready for the assignment.
And, Coach, I actually like this decision. I thought Bailey, you know, when he was called on last year, you know, even though I think he, as a starter he might have went 1-1, I know he played well versus Syracuse on a Thursday night. You know, the game was close, but he played well enough to give NC State an opportunity to win, and that's all, you know, Coach Dorn is going to ask of him. You know, just go out there, take care of the football. Don't try to do too much, like I always say about every quarterback, and allow your playmakers to make some plays, because Bam Knight, Emeka Emezi, these guys can make plays. So as long as he gives them opportunities, they'll be fine.
And we're going to need to see the skill around him step up. You know, again, they have playmakers. Thayer Thomas, again, another outlet that you can get to, a handful of tight ends. And Emeka Emezi, like you just mentioned, E, they have talent around them. Two running backs that are also very capable of handling this offense. But it's going to be fun to see. You know, you have a question mark with a quarterback. We all thought it was going one way. Last minute adjustment, or maybe last minute to us. So it's going to be fun to see this Wolfpack team. I know they are ready to get 2019 out of everybody's mind, injury riddled. Hopefully this is a new and improved team and guys that will be flying around on the defensive side of the ball as well.
EJ, is this almost an advantage of sorts for the Wolfpack at the quarterback position, but also the fact that we haven't seen the Wolfpack this year? We know who Wake is, at least from 1 week of film, versus Clemson. Is that an advantageous thing that they haven't played, or is it clearly a disadvantage that they haven't played?
Jordan, it's all about how you look at it. It could be an advantage as you're fresher, you don't have as many injuries, or, you know, you didn't play last week, so you don't have any bad or good juju coming into this game. You have a fresh and clean slate. But I think for Wake Forest, the advantage goes to them. I mean, they played against the number one team in the country, so naturally, you know, okay, we can't play anybody better than these guys, right? And so I think as far as for them, they want to go up against a team that they feel is probably more evenly matched. And I'm willing to say that, you know, a guy like Boogie Basham is, you know, going to pin his ears back. He's going to be a guy that's going to try to hit Hockman's face all night. So I would say the advantage overall goes to Wake Forest.
I'll tell you, what I hated as a coach was that first game of the year, or playing an opponent who's playing their first game of the year, because you're really not certain what they're going to do on defense. You're really not certain what they're going to do on offense. Even special teams, they might have a new wrinkle.
Coach, I think we're having an issue, Coach, with your mic there. I think we're having some technical issue. Emac, can you pick us up while we get Coach's mic right there?
Yeah, again, you're looking at two teams. You have that surprise factor. Are they going to be able to come in not knowing what NC State looks like, not having that first game under their belt due to, you know, the suspension, not playing the game at all? And so I think moving forward, it's that surprise tactic. But then again, I thought that was going to help Duke, right, and that experience that they had. But here we go. BC comes out firing. So we could, in fact, see that from NC State today.
Well, I'm excited to get a look at this quarterback with clearly some pressure on him, stepping in with only a touchdown and four interceptions from a season ago. But that's why they play the game. Bailey Hockman will get his shot. Wake Forest at NC State. Right now, Dave O'Brien, Tim Hasselbeck, Katie George on the call. Everybody enjoy more football.
Ready to get back on the gridiron, returning to Carter-Finley Stadium. They'll face an opponent they have played every year since 1910. Although lately, the Wake Forest Demon Deacons have had control of the series, winning the last three. Wake has already fallen to number one Clemson. That was a week ago, but it's opening night for the Wolfpack. We welcome you to ACC Network Football, presented by GEICO. Wake Forest and NC State from Raleigh, North Carolina. Great of you to join us. I'm Dave O'Brien, along with Tim Hasselbeck, my partner. We are working from our homes tonight. Tim, you know the Wolfpack couldn't be happier about getting back at it. Finally, they get on the field tonight.
They're excited about the opportunity to play at Carter-Finley Stadium. They've had their opener postponed, finally getting a chance against an ACC opponent, an in-state opponent. I know they're excited for the challenge.
Well, you know, it's been a bizarre and challenging journey through the pandemic for the Wolfpack, much different than most teams. Quick start last year in 2019, but then injuries decimated NC State and the bottom fell out. This summer, they began practice and then the pause button, and they had to stop practicing for a full week. The opener was changed from Virginia Tech to their old rival, Wake Forest, here tonight. And, Tim, Bailey Hockman is not going to start tonight. He is the presumed starting quarterback, but it's not going to be – it will be Bailey Hockman. It will not be Devin Leary, who will be the quarterback of the future. That's what they've said.
Yeah, and the plan was certainly not to start Bailey Hockman, but that is what Dave Doran is going with. Basically, Devin Leary in the quarterback competition, just unavailable for too much of training camp. And with that being the case, Dave Doran feels like Bailey Hockman is the quarterback that gives his team the best chance to win in their first game of this 2020 season, and that's why it's Bailey Hockman tonight.
Well, for more on the quarterback story, let's go down to the field and bring in Katie George. Katie?
Well, Dave Doran was very clear. Devin Leary was not beaten out. He was a victim of circumstances. When NC State had to shut down for the 8 days during preseason camp because of COVID-19, Devin Leary had to quarantine for almost 20 days because of contact tracing. He never felt ill, but once he was cleared to rejoin the team, there was just not enough time to reacclimate him in Tim Beck's new offense. Beck says it's an unfortunate situation, but at this point in time, they feel Bailey Hockman gives them the best chance to win.
All right, we will see how that works out tonight in what is finally game one for NC State. Now, Wake Forest, four consecutive bowl games. They, of course, have lost the opener to the Clemson Tigers, Tim, but there's been a lot of success here, particularly as of late.
There really has been, and Dave Clawson has done an excellent job recruiting talent, developing talent, and that's why, you know, when you and you said it earlier, Dave, they have had so much success the last three seasons against NC State. They run a unique offense, and it has given them fits.
Now, the starting quarterback will be Sam Hartman, who went 11 for 21, 182 yards against Clemson in the opener. NC State getting ready to get their offense rolling. Possibility of this one being a pretty high-scoring affair tonight. A lot of that's going to come down to what Bailey Hockman does for the Wolfpack. So we are set to go, as Wake Forest will kick off and get us underway here tonight. Beautiful night in Raleigh, North Carolina. And they'll bring it out to the 25-yard line. NC State, last year, very tough season, as we mentioned. And they have met Wake Forest more than any other opponent in their 128-year football history. This is the 114th meeting, with NC State holding a 66-41-6 advantage. So here's Hockman to run the offense, and the left-hander, Tim.
Yeah, the lefty, the transfer from Florida State, good athlete, does have a win under his belt as an NC State starting quarterback.
Well, he's going to throw it here, and it's going to be down low and incomplete on the first effort of the evening. So bring up second down. They did throw it backwards in a fumble on that play. So second down and 18. From the shotgun, there's Person. That opens up on the left side. He gets a big gap across the 30 and down the sideline before he is shoved out of bounds. Ricky Person with a big gainer right away.
But one of the ways you help a quarterback that's your unexpected starters run the football and run it well. Great movement by the guys up front. Ricky Person, all kinds of room to run.
Jacquez Williams eventually angling him out of bounds. So big gain right away. Hockman wants to throw, and he is going to fire that one incomplete. And a gain of 17. Thomas, there, Thomas with the reception.
It's a really nice job of Bailey Hockman there. They're running four verticals, and he's just able to get it in between the corner who's sinking and the safety that was up over the top.
Person to back. He'll get the carry off to the right side. Not much there for him. Person along with Bam Knight and Jordan Houston. The Wolfpack could have one of the deeper running back cores in the ACC.
And that will help them go tempo It's a little surprising to see them going so fast, though, Dave, considering, you know, they've had to pause training camp. They've had guys unavailable to practice. You wonder about their conditioning, but certainly an effort to go fast early in this game offensively.
Second down and seven. They're going to run it again, and that's going to be Bam Knight finding a big hole across the 10, and he is into the end zone. Well, that didn't take long, and a quick strike for NC State behind Zonovan Bam Knight for the touchdown.
But Dave, you talked about the depth at running back. Well, here's Bam Knight. He motions back into the backfield, and then just look at the movement, an amazing block. By the left guard at corner, just a pancake on Ryan Smenda, which allows Bam Knight really to go untouched into the end zone.
A 30-yard romp for Bam Knight, the sophomore out of Bailey, North Carolina. And NC State shot out of a cannon to get this one underway. And they have taken a 7-0 lead here in the first quarter. And they did that in a heartbeat.
They sure did, and it was all about the run game. And you know, this offensive line for NC State has played a decent amount of football together. Look at the movement, and then just look at the pancake block by 79 Aquanu. Then he goes and finishes him off again. And Bam Knight with easy work because of the job done of the guys up front.
You want to talk about a football team that was ready to go. They certainly looked it on the first series. So 7-0, the Wolfpack with 13:04 to go here in the first. And Wake Forest probably a little bit, more than a little bit, stunned. Wake last year 8-5, 4-4 in the ACC, earning a bid to the Pinstripe Bowl, losing to Michigan State eventually. And they are quickly down 7-0. NC State, two long runs of 30 or better. And into the end zone, it'll come on out to the 25-yard line, and that means that Sam Hartman gets an opportunity to counter. Now, last week against Clemson, 11 for 21, 182 yards. Difficult to make any kind of a judgment against the Tigers. That was his 11th start for Wake.
And Sam Hart had an opportunity to start as a true freshman, lost his job to Jamie Newman. Now with Jamie Newman's transfer, finds himself back in the starting quarterback role, I think with a greater appreciation for it.
He will throw on first down and complete to Beal Smith, and he's going to try and get to the sideline. Actually, Taylor Morn who made that catch. And picks up a first down right away. And on the carry, here's Beal Smith before he is dragged down. And this is the unique mesh style offense, Tim, we'll be getting a look at tonight. Very few schools run this.
Yeah, it's really unique to Wake Forest. It's kind of that ride read. You hear about the zone read, and this is similar to that, but it's this long mesh point right there between the quarterback and the back. Makes it so hard for the defense to figure out who has the football. And it also allows the quarterback to get a look at the defense to find if he wants to pull that ball out of the belly of the back and find his receiver in behind the linebackers.
Gain of one to bring up third down and six. And 11:54 to go here in the first quarter. He's back to throw. And looking long, deep to the sideline, that's going to be incomplete. Now battle with the good coverage, that right cornerback. On the long passing attempt, so fourth down and six.
And we see it every week, Dave, and we see these offenses that want to go fast. You know, it's important to also stay on the field. You know, you go too fast, all of a sudden the defense can feel like they're in a sudden change situation. You're not able to sustain the drive and get first downs.
So NC State with a 7-0 lead in just a couple of minutes in the first quarter. And Crane with the punt. And Thomas will watch that one bounce. So we'll take the break. 11:40 to go here in the first quarter at NC State. Up by 7.
It's about the run game, Dave. You mentioned it, two runs of over 30 yards, and it all started with great movement up front, guys blocking down the field. First it was Ricky Person, and then it was Bam Knight finishing it off for the score.
I'm not sure there's a better nickname for a running back in college football today than Bam Knight, and showing it right there. Person trying to get right into that pile, stopped by Tyler Williams.
I would agree with you on the Bam comic. I like Sam Bam Cunningham. Being a Boston guy, you're appreciating that, I'm sure.
You betcha I eat that up. Person in the backfield along with Bailey Hockman. You mentioned that Leary was going to be the guy. He was certainly going to be the starting quarterback this season. Person with another carry trying to get that edge, but he is shoved out. That's an interesting dynamic, Tim, for Devin Leary, because he knows how much the coaching staff and everybody on the NC State Wolfpack, how much they love him and his future. It's just not right this minute.
Yeah, and I think as uncomfortable and frustrating as it may be for Devin Leary, I think it's maybe even more uncomfortable for Bailey Hockman to know, hey, I'm the starter, but the guy I was competing with wasn't able to practice for nearly 3 weeks.
Hockman on 3rd and 8, going short here. It's Person again, his target. And nudged out. So Ricky Person very busy early on here. Taylor eventually got him and pushed him out. We mentioned that Wake Forest has won the last 3 meetings against NC State, 44-10 last season. First down and 10. Wolfpack trying to get their offense in a groove here. Hockman plenty of time, and now he's on the run. He gets flushed out, looking downfield to the 30-yard line, and out he goes.
And Bailey Hockman's looking to throw a slant to his left. Basically, there's not a window there for him to throw, and as he tries to escape to his right, he sees Boogie Basham and realizes that's a bad idea. Retraces his steps and is able to make a good decision with the football, hold on to it, and get out of bounds.
Generally a good idea to stay away from Boogie Basham anyway. The All-ACC defensive end, preseason All-American. Here's Bam Knight. He gets the carry. And taken down by both Masterson and Taylor on the defensive side for Wake Forest.
Lyle Hupp, the defensive coordinator for Wake Forest, not really knowing what he was going to get offensively from NC State, did expect with the stable of backs and the experience on the offensive line to see a heavy dose of the run game. Obviously, he got that in the first drive. Be interesting to see what their answer is. That's Wake Forest defense to that heavy run game.
Third down and 1. Knight, he pulls ahead. He gets the carry to pick up the first down. Stopped by Trevion Red, but not before the first down marker. And for more on Knight, let's toss it to Katie George.
Well, your guy Bam gained some weight this offseason. He said he found success running the ball last year, but he could tell physically his strength did not match those he faced in pass protection last season. So he got in the gym. He stopped being such a picky eater. He went from 195 to 15 pounds heavier, and he feels like it's helping him in pass pro this season.
Nothing wrong with putting on a couple, believe me. Pass over the middle, and this one complete. And a big gainer here. That'll go to Parham. The fullback comes out and makes a big catch.
Well, after you're running the football so well, your little play action gets those linebackers to step up. And Parham, exactly right, sneaks behind those linebackers. And that's why he's wide open behind them in that hole of the defense.
Well, the Wolfpack showing quite a variety here in the first quarter, already up 7-0. And moving the chains, that play going for 32 yards. And really moving the football here on Wake. First down and 10 on a play action. Good pressure on him, and he fires it up, and that'll be caught. Carter with the grab.
You see another really nice play by Bailey Hawkman. Off of the play action, he's got two seams. The safety's favoring the inside seams. Outside, he's able to shoot the ball to Carter. Kind of an off-platform throw. Well done by the lefty quarterback.
Gain of 21. Houston's going to run it and off into the end zone. It's Hawkman there. And NC State with another touchdown as they have taken a 13-0 lead.
Well, how about this start for Bailey Hawkman? You know, not only as a passer with a couple of good throws there, but as a runner, design run, basically student-bodied left. Quarterback's able to follow the running back as a lead blocker. That's good play design. It's good execution.
Houston with a terrific block there. And the extra point makes it 14-0, NC State.
Bailey Hawkman was a surprise starter, but he's playing every bit like a starter, leading the Wolfpack to a 14-0 lead.
ACC Network Primetime Football is presented by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Now the NC State student athletes referring to their social justice movement as Pack United. And during the jersey reveal this week, the football team also debuted the uniform patch they'll be wearing this fall. The Wilson College of Textiles helped create the patches to show further support for Pack United. And let's go down to Katie.
Well, Dave, the patch consists of a black fist with three words surrounding it: education, action, and awareness, the three pillars the Pack United Student Athlete Initiative is built on. Isaiah Moore, a team captain and a co-founder of the group, says the objective is to denounce racial injustice and police brutality while also promoting equality and unity, and they are very appreciative of the students from the textile program who produced the patches and sewed them on every jersey prior to tonight's game.
A wonderful effort there. They look terrific, by the way. They did a great job on those. NC State with a 14-0 lead. They're getting inspiration from every place. And Wake Forest trying to answer. Walker on the run, but he gets into a tangle. He's taken down. Kenneth Walker stopped a gain of one. Tackled by Drake Thomas. So second down and nine for the Demon Deacons. Hardman, and that one fired into the flat, and right on the money, Roberson, Ja'Quarri Roberson, who had four catches for 92 yards, had a very good game, Tim, against Clemson. This one goes for 10.
He did, Dave. Even though they've had some, they've lost some pass catchers from a year ago, I do think they have a good young group here at Wake Forest.
Hardman showing off that arm strength right there. And a completed pass. That goes for nine to A.T. Perry. A.T. Perry, big receiver, big target at 6'5", 210.
Yeah, built like Scotty Washington from a year ago on that one. You said big arm by Hardman. You're right, he needed it to be because that was a small window throw.
Walker going into the pile in the center of the line. And he stopped for zero gain. Well, that's one thing that we found out being around Coach Clawson a lot last year. He likes big receivers.
And I think it goes well with what they want to do offensively, because oftentimes you're reading a conflict defender, but then when you're throwing the football to a wide receiver and you're expecting them to make a contested catch, obviously big-bodied receivers traditionally good at doing that.
Bill Smith on the carry on third and short, and Wake convinced they've got it. They do have a first down.
And interesting to see that there, Dave. Jamie Newman, quarterback a year ago at 235 pounds, was very good at doing that on short yard situations running the football. Instead, it basically was Christian Beal Smith in that role of kind of putting the belly in the putting the ball in the belly of the back and then keeping it as the runner.
It makes you wonder how much time it takes to get this down, the nuances of this mesh style. Hartman with plenty of time in the pocket, and again, a good, strong delivery and a completed pass as he got that one to Donovan Green, and that's a gain of 9 yards.
Well, Dave, I do think it takes a long time to be comfortable with it, to get good at, you know, trusting that mesh point and the discipline with your eyes and the back having the discipline of knowing that the quarterback may pull the ball out of his belly when he's getting ready to run with the football. And that's why I think it's been important for them to have continuity at Wake Forest and continue to rep this system that they've become so good at doing.
Second and two, that's Walker, and a big hole opens up as he dives across and picks up the first down, stopped by Drake Thomas eventually, but a gain of 8.
And this run, a little bit different design. You're going to see guys pulling around, basically, you know, the right guard and right tackle pulling around, end up as the lead blocker.
Hardman going up top, looking for the end zone, and incomplete. So looking for the strike to get 6 of those back right away. Good coverage by Battle.
And that, you know, one of the things about those shot plays with these big wide receivers, you know, as Donovan Green goes 6'2", is you want to give them a chance to touch the football. You know, you don't want it to be a long foul ball. I mean, it's basically a wasted play when you don't give your receiver a chance to touch the ball.
Ninth play of the drive, and it's going to be Walker trying to bounce outside before he's taken down. Are you surprised that both sides are going this quickly, Tim?
I am a little bit early in the season, and it is what Wake wants to do, so it probably shouldn't be a surprise. Obviously, Tim Beck, that's his background to go fast. But I do think you have to worry about conditioning.
Walker bouncing outside across the 30-yard line, staying on his feet to pick up extra yardage. Kenneth Walker with the carry, the sophomore out of Arlington, Tennessee. And Drake Thomas with the stop eventually, but a good gain. That's 13. And no huddle for Wake. Out of the shotgun, Hartman off the fake. Looking to throw to the sideline. That one complete to Roberson. Roberson staying on his feet before he's dragged down. You mentioned Jamie Newman, you know, the former quarterback. And Dave Clawson had said he was caught completely off guard by Newman's transfer to Georgia. Lost his starting quarterback. And then, of course, opted out at UGA because of COVID concerns. He said, you know, he was a really good teammate, did a great job here. As Walker stays on his feet. Boy, the second effort, that ball came loose. NC State picks it up. Malik Dunlap, the corner, fell on that.
But it was a big hit prior to that. See the collision there. Looked like it was Jakeem Harris. Maybe put his helmet on the football. And popped it out. That looked like the ball was out to me.
Yep, and they definitely want to take a look. 14-0 NC State with 3:51 to go here in the first.
I think Jakeem Harris, you know, as Kenneth Walker kind of is stood up a little bit, just kind of spins off the tackler, and here comes Jakeem Harris, and boom, kind of that helmet shoulder pad on the ball. And you know, unless they're saying progress, and that would have to have had been a really quick whistle.
Yeah, that ball looks like it's loose, and he's still moving, so this play is under review.
Given Jakeem Harris credit for knocking it out, but I think it's Dunlap ripping at the football that ultimately gets it free before he's able to jump back on top of it. This would be a big stop by that NC State defense, because they started to become a rhythm and a tempo that I think was starting to lean on NC State a little bit there as that drive got going, and you know, creating a turnover inside the red zone. So it'll be a big play, big momentum change.
Yeah, Wake Forest really had it rolling there with 5 first downs on the drive. So waiting to see what they come up with here on the review. To this point, all Wolfpack. Dave Doran's been talking about it all week long, just how much his kids were really dying to get on the field and start playing football again. And it had been such a long time coming. So Wake Forest will retain possession, so they ruled no fumble. It is first and goal then for the Demon Deacons. And a handoff for Walker. Walker getting a lot of action here in the latter stages of this first quarter.
And they feel like Kenneth Walker is one of the best backs they've had, under Dave Clawson here at Wake Forest. Played a bit as a freshman, now as a sophomore, I think a little bit stronger than he was a year ago. And they think he can be a real complete back.
Second and goal. Hartman looking to throw. Has time. Good protection. Go for the end zone. The catch made. And it is a touchdown. Roberson getting up high. And he beat Battle on the coverage for the touchdown.
It's a really nice job by Sam Hartman. He actually wants to go to his right. You see his eyes wanting to start to his right. He's kind of late getting to this corner route. But he puts it up high where his receiver, Roberson, can go up and get it. That left foot is down, control of the football. That's a heck of a catch in the back of the end zone.
Well, Jaquari had one for 55 yards against Clemson a week ago. So Nick Skibo, one of the top kickers in the country, even though he missed a couple last week against Clemson, that was a real head scratcher. He's about as good as it gets. Last year made 24 out of 25. And on for the extra point here for Wake Forest. And he will drill it. So the Demon Deacons on the board.
What a response by Wake Forest. Down 14-0. The offense back on the field. And Sam Hartman delivers to his big wide receiver.
Wake Forest on the board, 14 plays, 75 yards, an impressive drive, Tim, 4 minutes and 26 seconds into the end zone.
It was an excellent response, a little fortunate with the turnover that wasn't a turnover, and Sam Hartman does an excellent job of having some poise in the pocket, working across the field and delivering a nice throw. They really needed it with the way NC State had been running the football on them.
Yeah, they were running at will and piled up a 14-0 lead, but Wake Forest has cut that in half. And so Crane to kick off. And again, through the back of the end zone out to the 25. It comes, our Geico player spotlight. You talk about a star and Boogie Basham, the All-ACC defensive end for Wake Forest, preseason All-American. 11 sacks and 18 tackles for a loss last season.
He's an excellent all-around football player. You see Todd McShay has him 14th in the 2021 NFL draft rankings. Super productive. Anybody that we've talked to in preparing for Wake Forest games, they have their eye on number 9. They've seen his production, and they know that he can wreck a game.
So NC State looking to answer, and they are really moving the football. Basham 19 consecutive games with a tackle for a loss. Masterson with a stop on Houston. So that'll bring up second down and 8. And whistles. And that will stop play at 2:53 to go in the quarter. NC State with tremendous injury problems last year. They lost 12 full or part-time starters to injuries for at least 4 games.
I remember talking to Dave Doran last year during that, and he said, I don't know what it is, but at some point we are going to benefit from going through this adversity. And then when he talked about kind of what this offseason has been for his first football team, he thought, they've been through some shared adversity, and I think our team's going to come out a lot stronger because of it.
Hockman, here's Person. Actually, Jordan Houston will scamper outside of the sideline. And he's going to pick up 13 yards on that carry before he's forced out by Zion Keith, who had 12 tackles in the opener against Clemson. That was the most in the ACC. Pick up the first down. Pitching it again. And again, it's Houston.
Well, you see it. It's basically the Urban Meyer influence on Tim Beck. That little, you know, kind of touch pass to Jordan Houston, get his speed to the edge. They're running two plays in a row. The second time, Ja'Cory John's just not fooled by it.
You mentioned Tim Beck, the new offensive coordinator for NC State, formerly with Ohio State and with Texas. And this is an offense that really needs the help. Last year, the Pack averaging only 16 points per game. Some of the worst offensive numbers in school history lately. As Knight gets to the sideline, Bam Knight taken down by Masterson. But that's going to lose 4 yards.
Well, Dave, you mentioned, you know, the offense a year ago and their struggles. We saw them a number of times, and they just weren't explosive offensively. And I think in this first quarter, we've seen a few runs of over 30 yards and some big chunk plays in the passing game. They seem to at least be headed in the right direction.
Well, Hockman all by himself in the backfield on 3rd and 14. The junior out of Powder Springs, Georgia, back to throw, and now he's going to run it. Staying on his feet, getting around the 50-yard line, and a good gain there. So Hockman taken off, taken down by Nasir Greer.
We saw it on the touchdown run. He has the ability. You know, he's not necessarily thought of as a running threat, but they're in empty. Guys downfield take off and run with it.
Then a handoff for Person trying to center the line. And the gain by Hockman went for 14. Smendo with the tackle. That picks up 1 yard. Carter-Finley Stadium here in Raleigh, North Carolina. ACC Network Football. NC State taking on the Wake Forest Demon Deacons and the Wolfpack opener. And they certainly looked like they were raring to go the way they were shot out of a cannon in the first couple of drives. And a handoff for Houston. Takes a pretty good pop. Last season, NC State only managed 10 points in their loss to Wake Forest. Well, they already have 14 at the end of one quarter here tonight. College football continues next weekend on ACC Network. Another triple header at noon. Number 18, Louisville against number 25, Pitt. At 4 o'clock, it's Duke and Virginia. And then at 8 o'clock, NC State taking on number 20, Virginia Tech. ACC Network football next Saturday beginning at noon on the ACC Network. NC State so far 3-for-3 on third downs. A lot of efficiency with this offense. Under Bailey Hockman, he's going to air it out again, and a complete pass. And they're going to pick up a first down. Emezi with the catch, taken down by McCollum. And that's a gain of 15, and they're right back at it again. Off the play action. He'll fire it again, and that one is going to be complete. For another big gainer and caught by Angeline, the tight end. That's really, a gain of 30.
It's a fake wide receiver screen. Angeline bluffs the block and then he gets up the sideline. It's a really well played, really good play design, really well seen and executed by Bailey Hockman.
Hockman trying to follow those blockers, get down close to the goal line on first and goal. Hockman with the carry. He's already punched one in tonight. That's a gain of 1. But he's already scored a touchdown for the Wolfpack. So using his legs as well as his arm. Man, has he been impressive here in this first half.
He's been fantastic. I mean, he's done an excellent job for, you know, a guy that was coming into training camp not as a starter, ends up getting, you know, the job. And the coaches talked about they trust him operating the offense, making good decisions. We've seen exactly that tonight.
Now throwing the ball 9 for 9, 134 yards. The snap comes to the back and in for a touchdown. Person across for 6 more. And NC State rolling up the offense here in the first half.
They are, and they're doing it with the run game. And this time it's Bailey Hoffman, the quarterback, going in motion out to wide receiver. The direct snap, it catches Wake Forest a bit off guard. And then just powering it into the end zone.
And leading it 20-7, NC State, 3 rushing touchdowns by 3 different players. You talk about variety. And as you say, putting the quarterback in motion, which you don't see every day.
It's just what you do with athletes, Dave, is you use them any way you can.
Unsportsmanlike conduct here with 13:36 to go in the second quarter. Well, the Wolfpack on full attack.
The play was over. Unsportsmanlike conduct. Number 8, offense. That 15-yard penalty will be enforced on the kickoff.
That was Ricky Person who just scored that touchdown. And this was it.
I tell you what, I know guys aren't supposed to show good sportsmanship.
These guys have
been through a lot. They're excited to be playing football. They're excited to end up in the end zone.
Yeah.
I say go ahead and dance, Ricky.
You know, especially after this start. And that will make it 21-7. NC State really sharp here in the first half at home. Well, look at this. 30-yard plays against Wake Forest. NC State last year in the entire ballgame didn't have one. Already, Tim, 4 tonight.
Well, Dave Doran said he needed an experienced play caller. He got that with Tim Beck. And I think what Tim Beck has done in this short offseason with no spring ball has been remarkable in the early start of this football game.
Wolfpack with drives of 75, 82, and 75 yards. Well, we're talking about that mesh offense.
And it's so unique. Look at the quarterback walk up with the running back. 8 steps right next to the running back. Who has the football? So hard for the defense to tell. And then as a defense, if you want to commit to stop that run, because you're trying to figure out who has the ball, the quarterback reads that conflict defender, pulls the ball out of the belly of the back, and can find big plays in the passing game. It's one of the things that makes the offense so unique, so difficult to defend, and one of the reasons they can score quickly on you.
Sam Hartman, 6 for 8, 52 yards and a touchdown so far. And wants to throw it here, shown a very strong arm. That one going to be complete to Morin. So that'll be a gain for the Demon Deacons of 10. And bring up first and 10 again for Sam Hartman, a sophomore out of Cornelius, North Carolina. With the handoff, Beal Smith, but they cover him quickly.
And I think we're going to see a little more traditional drop back with Sam Hartman as the quarterback rather than Jamie Newman. We'll also see less quarterback runs. But you've referenced it a few times, the strong arm of Sam Hartman. That ball does look like it's popping out of his hands.
And another completion. That'll be caught by Stewart. Donald Stewart, the senior. So he is spraying it around. And with Jamie Newman gone, Hartman could be Wake's quarterback for 3 years. Hartman came into tonight saying, well, I'm experienced, sort of. Although he has about 3,000 yards of total offense. Got the start against FSU last year. And he has posted a pair, Tim, of 300-yard passing games. So he has known a little bit of success.
Look at the passer. Number 11. Defense. 15-yard penalty and an automatic first down.
Automatic first down, 15 yards.
Got it. Just see Hartman here That's just down low, and anytime you see Peyton Wilson come in low there, that's the right decision to throw that flag. And Sam Hartman, you mentioned, has had some success. I've been impressed when I've seen him play, Dave. I think he's a tough competitor. I think he's a good passer. I think he's a good fit in this offense.
A little bit of a hole there for Beal Smith on the carry. Stopped by Wilson. That's a gain of five. You know, it's not like he's 17, 18 years old. He turned 21 years old this summer, so there's some experience there, too. And nothing doing on the carry by Beal Smith. And once again, it was Peyton Wilson who said hello.
It's Peyton Wilson atoning for the late hit. They just bring him off of the edge there, and it really should have been picked up. Goes unblocked, and big collision in the backfield.
Third down and eight. That lost 3 yards. And flags again with 11:36 to go here in the second quarter. Having obviously some problems with the microphones tonight with the officials. They work every once in a while. I'd say about one out of every four at this point. So hopefully they'll get those fixed. Third down and 13.
Third down. It's 2020. Taking 25% success rate is, I think, acceptable at this point.
Wake, by the way, 3 out of 4 on third down. Hardman will throw into the flat and complete to Stewart again. Made a couple of catches on this particular drive. Let's see what they do here. That's a gain of 3 yards.
And you kind of find yourself in no man's land here in this decision to keep the offense out on the field, even on 4th and 11. Probably the right decision.
So he's back to throw into the pocket right down the middle, and that one is complete on another great throw. And again, it's Mourn complete.
It is a great throw. Not great route distribution. I think maybe it was a little bit of confusion with Mourn and Whitehart both running down the middle of the field, but Hartman does a good job of getting that ball up and down into the middle of the field.
So they move it into the red zone. First down and 10 here for Wake. And again, that mesh offense trying to bounce outside is Beal Smith heading for the end zone. He dives for the pylon, and he is in for a touchdown. Well, a heck of a run here to get in for 6 on a play that for a few seconds didn't look like it was going anywhere.
But it was going somewhere, Dave, because you know why? The quarterback block. It's that long mesh, as you called, walking Beal Smith up to the line of scrimmage, and then as he bounces it backside, Sam Hartman just becomes a football player. Quarterback block kind of springs him. I mean, already in this season, we've seen 2 of them. This one springs the running back for a score.
No doubt, Skiba on for the extra point, and he will nail it. 2 teams, 6 drives, 5 touchdowns. Well, you said this was, you know, possibly going to be very high scoring, and it's looking that way.
Offside.
Great response.
Defense
on 4th and 11.
22.
Quick offense a chance. Next thing you know, it's Beal Smith in for the score.
ACC Network Primetime Football, presented by GEICO, is brought to you by Bojangles. Feed the family with bone-in fried chicken, boneless chicken supreme, scratch-made biscuits, and fix-ins. It's bow time.
Man, if you like offense, you like this one. And how about inside PNC Arena, where we are going to have college basketball coming up this season? Trust me on that. Of course, the NCAA announcing this week, games are scheduled to begin on the 25th of November. Can't wait for that here in ACC country. Ricky Person, who's had a really fine first half here for NC State, and so has the quarterback, Bailey Hawkman, who is 9 for 9 to 8 different receivers tonight.
That's a remarkable start when you think about, you know, I guess the uneasiness, if you will, but the fact that their quarterback competition was disrupted by, you know, the virus situation making its way through the program, and Bailey Hawkman has been as good as you possibly could be so far.
We're starting from the 25-yard line, the FSU transfer. gives them a veteran presence, but it was a surprise. Devin Leary was supposed to be the starting quarterback. Going to swing that one outside to Rooks on a complete pass, but it's going to lose a yard and bring up second down and 11. NC State pausing all fall sports on the 24th of August because of a cluster tied to athletics, and the football program did not practice for a week. Leary never got sick, but he missed 20 days and just couldn't bounce back from that. Big carry here by Bam Knight as he'll move across for 7. Another one's very tough to bring down on that first effort.
Dave, you mentioned, you know, missing 20 days. You just, as a quarterback, timing's important. Command is important, and it's a new offense. And so I think Dave Doran, you know, had to make the tough decision of just understanding the value of that and the value of the reps, and with Bailey Hawkman's availability, just was more comfortable with him operating the offense.
Knight again trying to find the edge outside, but not much there. As Bam Knight got the carry and Anderson set high.
It really seems like NC State wants to work this left side of their offensive line. Let those guys move. You know, Tyrone Wiley and Icky, as they call him, Aquanu, the left guard, two big bodies that move well and done a good job of getting movement so far.
The stop by Nasir Green, and again it's Bam Knight. So second down and 9 here for the Wolfpack. Got off to a pretty decent start a season ago, but they would lose 6 in a row to close the season. Just tremendous injury problems and a jump at the line and a flag down. 8:46 to go in the half. Wolfpack trying to break a 3-game losing skid to Wake Forest.
Offside with contact, number 7, defense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Yeah, for NC State, particularly, Tim, in the COVID age, the challenge of hiring 5 new coaches, including the 2 primary coordinators, that had to be immense for Dave Doran. Not to mention for his kids, but that had to be incredibly challenging for everybody.
Everybody involved. And a lot of times when you are bringing into a new system to a program, you think, oh, the players have to learn the terminology, learn the system. Well, the other coaches had to learn the terminology and learn the system. And then the coaches that are new, they need to learn the players and what the players are good at doing. It's such a challenge when you have to pause your training camp.
Knock going to fire into the flat, and that one complete to Carter. Devin Carter, he is doing a great job, don't you think, of moving the football around and hitting a variety of wide receivers.
Spreading the football around, you know, they did say they feel like the depth of the wide receiver group is the strength of the group. When you think of how good they've been on third down, I mean, look, obviously if you're 12 for 12, you're completing a lot of passes, but third down, they're 6 for 6. A year ago, they really struggled on third down.
Now, Bailey Hawkman has been perfect tonight on play action. Now he's going to run it again. Now he's going to throw it again. That's going to be incomplete. So one of the few times they did not look too sure what they were doing here in the first half. That'll bring up second down and 10. That is his first incompletion in tonight's game after going 12 for 12.
Which means now everyone's allowed to talk to him.
So that's what it's like. When you're perfect like that in football, it's like the guy throwing the no-hitter, right?
12 for 12, that might have been the equivalent of like the third inning. But yeah, okay, it's okay now.
Throwing short, and that one complete to Houston. Jordan Houston on the quick strike. That's a 6-yard pickup for NC State.
I'm watching this NC State offense. It's everybody's first opportunity to get a look at it, what it's going to look like with Tim Beck as the play caller. And there is no question there has been a diversity of design in terms of what they've done offensively. Screens, moving the quarterback, running the quarterback, shots down the field. Been really impressed with the variety that we've seen so far, not to mention with how they've run the ball.
Well, they're 6 for 6 on third down. Third down and 4 for the Wolfpack. Hockman looking to fire again and too low and incomplete. So a couple of pretty impressive streaks here to get the game underway have just expired on this drive for NC State.
I think that really was the first bad throw of the night by Hockman. He's going to the right spot with the football. It's a little low. Receiver's not able to make a play on it and leads to their first punt.
Taylor Morn back to receive the punt. 6:42 to go in the half. And a 21-14 lead for NC State. A flag down here. So a 24-yard punt and a flag on the play. So 6.5 minutes to go here, and again we continue to have issues with the officials and their microphones here tonight at Carter-Finley Stadium.
Illegal formation, more than 4 players in the backfield, offense. That 5-yard penalty will be added onto the end of the run. First down, timeout.
And we have a timeout. NC State in front, 21-14 in the ACC. .634 to go before halftime here in Raleigh. NC State with a 21-14 lead on Wake Forest. And these are parents and the cutouts, and they are obviously watching the game very quietly. So in this case, there are some people, Tim, in the stadium here tonight as the Wolfpack gives way now to Wake Forest and a completed pass to Roberson, taken down by Baker Williams. That's a 13-yard gain. So some of the parents are allowed here in the stadium, about, what, 350 of them altogether.
That's a new development.
First down and 10.
Good to have them in town.
Hartman with the pass out of bounds and incomplete. Katie has more on that story.
Well, I can say that there's probably about 100 parents here in the stands at Carter-Finley. As of Thursday, the North Carolina Public Health Department announced that 350 spectators would be allowed at live football games. NC State got 250. Wake Forest got 100 tickets, and we're talking about 100 people in the stands, guys.
Hardman back to pass and complete over the middle. Just shy of the 50-yard line to A.T. Perry. A.T., pretty good-sized target at 6'5", 210.
And that was a good example of something that Hartman's improved at doing, just kind of poising the pocket as he climbed to find an A.T. Perry.
Walker getting a lot of carries here in the first half, trying to center of the line. That'll gain just one before Isaiah Moore made the stop. Second down, 9. Trouble. Hartman's going to go down as he gets buried and lost the helmet. Drake Thomas with the sack. That is going to lose 5 yards.
Yeah, just good fight by Drake Thomas. They bring a pressure. Kenneth Walker is able to just get a piece of the blitzer, but that forces Hartman to climb up into the pocket. And just the continued pursuit gets to him. And with Hartman's helmet coming off, I mean, he has to exit the play for the game for a play.
Yeah, for one play.
Third and long, you get the backup quarterback, Michael Kern.
Kern is in, out of the shotgun. And back to throw with a little bit of time. Still has time. Now he's going to roll out to his right, being chased down, and he will fire that one out of bounds. A flag is down. Jones giving chase. Levi Jones was about to take him down. 5:01 to go here in the second quarter. So another flag here.
Offside. Defense. Holding, number 59, offense. Those fouls offset. Third down.
And Hartman is back in after losing the helmet two plays ago.
Kind of impressed the way Kern just stood there in the pocket, straight off the sideline to hang in there like that. Impressive, but now kind of back to square one on third and long with your starting quarterback.
Hardman to throw and rifles that one and another completion. That one caught by Roberson. Oh, Jaquari having a really fine half, and that one was on the money. That goes for 24, but another flag is down.
Illegal formation. Offense. Number 53 was in the backfield, putting more than four players in the backfield. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. Third down.
So an illegal formation. And they're going to back it up to third down and 19. NC State 4-8 last year, just 1-7 in the ACC. Wake Forest at 8-5, went 4-4 in the conference, a bid to the Pinstripe Bowl. And they've got a very challenging schedule coming up. North Carolina, Chapel Hill, they get Virginia, they get Louisville. A tremendous leaping catch there once again by Roberson in traffic. He hauled that in somehow. That's 23 yards.
It's basically the same route that he just ran. Roberson working in the slot does a good job.
Play clock to 25 seconds.
Stacking the defender, and that's an excellent throw. It's like twice in a row on third and long by Sam Harden. Really incredible what they've done. Hit a seam on fourth and 11 a previous drive. Now third and 19, another seam. Really work in the middle of the field.
Big first down for Wake. And Hartman handing off once again. That's Walker, who bounces outside across the 30 before he's dragged down from behind. That's a 10-yard gain.
It's a really nice run by Kenneth Walker. They talk about, you know, how he's, you know, really one of the better backs they've had here. Look at the patience and the job of the guys up front just sticking to their blocks, continuing to fight. Then Kenneth Walker with good vision, patience, able to bounce it outside.
They've got a man down for NC State. That is Daniel Joseph, the 6'3", 265-pounder from Toronto. So 3:44 to go and a man down here. He's a grad transfer from Penn State, originally recruited by Dave Doran 4 years ago. We'll see if he is all right. 21-14, NC State. Well, Joseph up and walking around on the sideline after he had to leave. Going down for a moment. Good news for NC State that he looks okay. 3:49 to go here. First down and 10. And both sides racking up some offense here in the first half in Raleigh. One of my favorite cities in the South. Love Raleigh, North Carolina.
Yeah, we've enjoyed our time down there when we've been at NC State. And Carter-Finley Stadium, typical circumstances, a great game day environment. It's one of the things that Dave Doran actually talked about, it probably hurt in recruiting a little bit, is when recruits get on campus, they really like it there on game day.
Can absolutely see why. Hartman has had a good half. He's going to hand off here for Walker, who cuts it back. Still on his feet after the initial hit. He's done that several times here in the first half. And that's going to pick up 12 yards.
It is Kenneth Walker kind of just finding his way through there. You know, I love it. Sam Hartman going to get in the way again as he decides to bounce it back. And then great finish to the run by Kenneth Walker.
Anytime a quarterback makes a block or even thinks about making a block, you're going to hear about it on our broadcast. First down and 10.
That's pretty accurate. All he has to do is actually think about it. He actually doesn't even think about it. Just dream about it.
Low snap, but it's Walker again trying to slice inside as the clock runs, taken down by Drake Thomas. So a 3-yard gain there from Walker, who has been the primary back here, and not so much Christian Beal-Smith in the first half of Wake. They are trying to get even here with 2:11 to go before the break. Walker again, the running back alongside Hartman, who's gone 14 for 17, 151 yards passing. Walker with another carry, and he'll dive ahead.
And Dave, I'm really impressed at the power that Kenneth Walker is running with. We saw him a year ago, and you know, he was fast. You could see his speed and the elusiveness. He didn't have this kind of power. Now up over 200 pounds. The way he's finishing some of these runs, been really impressive so far.
Key carry here if he gets it on 3rd and 4. He had some really nice games last year as a freshman. 125 yards against Rice. He had 113 yards against Duke. He was also a talented wide receiver out of high school in Memphis. Harmon's going to race ahead now as he gets across 10-yard line and inside the 5 before he's taken down. That's a pickup of 5 yards for the quarterback.
That's a really big play by Sam Hartman. Wasn't sure he was going to have enough speed to get away from those linebackers to pick up the first down. Does it there.
It's coming out of the game now. So Hartman has gone to the sideline, but a big pickup there to make it first and goal.
You see the Wildcat look with two backs in the backfield.
Final seconds of the first half. And Walker takes it. He's going to race in for another touchdown. Kenneth Walker, big first half here for Wake. And he scores the touchdown. Wake, 3 straight touchdown drives of 75 yards.
I talked about the diversity of play calling on the North Carolina State offensive side. Well, same thing for Wake Forest. We've seen that long mesh point, and now we've seen just lead blocking with two backs in the backfield, basically saying, you know what we're doing. Our quarterback is off the field. That's good job by the guys up front. And that's a walk-in touchdown from inside the 5. That's well done for that Wake offense.
Javonte Nash with a terrific block, the right tackle up front. 21-21.
You see it here. Just a lead block, too, by Christian Beal-Smith. And Sam Hartman excited. He's been in the weight room with Kenneth Walker. He's excited about it. Hey, listen, he's been blocking. He's allowed to celebrate with the other guys blocking. They should be excited about how they've responded. Obviously, down 14-0, continuing to fight back after getting punched in the mouth to start this thing. The response by this Wake Forest football team has been impressive. Part of probably the benefit of playing a game already this season, but good poise. And when you think about the opportunity to receive the ball in the second half, all that double dip that coaches are always looking for, score at the end of the half and then get the ball to start the second half.
And no panic there at all by Wake Forest. Walker, by the way, 5 carries, 30 yards on that drive. So he's been the man in their offense. So they will bring it out. And you look at these drives by Wake Forest, impressive to say the least. 14 plays, 75 yards, 9 and 75. The last one, 12 and 75. They like that number, and another touchdown.
Yeah, that's a lot of plays. That's obviously a lot of efficiency. Good on third down, and there's been balance. You know, I mean, it seems like we've been almost evened up with run and pass for that Wake offense. We've already seen almost 500 yards of offense from both teams.
Well, Dave Clawson said, he said, on my list of concerns, quarterback is not one of them. And Hartman is living up to that. Still on his feet, it's Houston bowling ahead, and a very determined rush here by Houston.
timeout.
So 27 seconds to go. And NC State will take a timeout.
This is a 30-second timeout.
Take a look at Houston here.
Yeah, it's interesting, you know. Wake Forest got really soft defensively. Basically, three guys deep, you know, what you would talk about as a prevent defense. But no one told Jordan Houston that the half was over, and he finishes that run, and Ryan Smendel doesn't get him down. And now, all of a sudden, this drive that looked like maybe was going to end in North Carolina State being happy to go to halftime. He's gotten the ball near midfield, and I think at this point, with how the quarterback has played, the timeout situation with one left, you know, you should be in business here to try to come away with some points.
Moving toward the 50-yard line here. That was a 21-yard run by Jordan Houston. Bailey Hockman at one point was 12 for 12 before his first incompleted pass. All tied up at 21. And the lefty trying to get out of trouble. He fires it up there, and a pass that's going to be incomplete out of bounds. So 20 seconds to go. And second down and 10 for Hockman.
You know, you almost wonder how many times they've had the opportunity to rep these situations. Coaches love to rep end of half, end of game situations. But now you're doing it with a quarterback that, you know, maybe didn't have the opportunities, or a team that didn't have a chance to practice some of these situations.
And whistles before they got the playoff and another timeout.
They're first of the half. This will be a 30-second.
So Wake takes one. It's been an entertaining first half with plenty of points. Both offenses hurrying up. No huddle style and mesh style offense for Wake Forest, which eventually caught fire. Look at NC State with 280 total yards and Wake at 231.
Yeah, and you know, I would typically say that, you know, when you miss practices, when you don't have a typical set of preparation, you know, days and practices leading into a game, that would favor the defense because of the timing and precision that's typically needed for offenses. But both groups have done a nice job. Both quarterbacks have played well, and you know, the way the offensive lines have worked together, I think, has also been impressive.
Second down, 10. Hockman back to throw again. He's flushed out of there. Now he cuts it back, looking downfield. He'll throw long and out of bounds. You know, Bailey Hockman was not supposed to start this game. It was going to be Devin Leary, you know, many weeks ago. He was supposed to start it. We've detailed that tonight. Hockman is playing the position like he's been a three-year starter. And Sam Hartman's a guy who came in when Jamie Newman left the program. And now it's his program and could be for 3 years. And he's looked like a guy who's been here for 2 or 3 years, starting every night.
You just never know when you're going to get your opportunity. It's why coaches say stay ready and just try to take advantage of it when it comes.
This time Hockman's going to go down as the defense gets to him, and it's Basham all over him as he will pick up the sack.
Yeah, the half.
So that's the end of the half. It ends on a terrific defensive play by one of the best defensive players in the conference, and Boogie Basham, the All-ACC defensive end. Entertaining half, to be sure. NC State 21. Wake Forest 21.
Welcome into the ACCN Halftime Report. I'm your host, Jordan Cornett, Eric McLean, E.J. Manuel. And this one has been an entertaining first half. Fellas, let's take a look at the highlight, what we have so far. Look at Coach Dorn and his squad set for their season debut. But how would they come out of the gates with a new quarterback? But it was the running game early. Zevannon Knight gets the handoff, takes it to the house. The touchdown, NC State 7-0. Next, Wolfpack possession. This time deep in Wake territory again. Bailey Hockman getting the start, getting the touchdown. NC State leads 14-0 early. Still in the first quarter, whole lot of action here out of the gate. Sam Hartman, questions at quarterback there for Wake Forest, seem to be answered early. Ja'Cory Roberson for the touchdown, puts the Demon Deacons on the board. This one all knotted up. KG, Katie George with Coach Dorn.
Dave, Wake Forest is able to score on the last three drives to close out the half. What do you need to see from your defense moving forward in the next two quarters?
We've got to get off the field on third down. I mean, we're just not making any plays on third down, pass rush and coverage. We're getting them into third and long and not converting.
Offensively, Bailey Hockman, he starts the game 9-for-9. What did you think of his efficiency and your offense's ability to run the ball?
Right now, they're doing well. I mean, they're moving up and down the field for the most part. They got stopped in one drive, and we got to clean up the penalties a little bit, too. We're hurting ourselves that way.
Thank you for the time.
All right, thank you.
Fellas, the quarterbacks were the story here in the first half. Bailey Hockman gets that start for the Wolfpack. Emac, what did you like?
Man, he's balling. The confidence is amazing. I think he started 12 for 12 at one point, and then he just had to throw it away. That was his first miss, was not taking a sack. It was a great move, a smart play, but, of course, it counts as a miss. He's playing really, really well. Both these quarterbacks are, but excited what we're seeing from him production-wise, getting a bunch of guys involved. And, again, in the running game, anything they want's really there. But, EJ, again, both these quarterbacks balling right now.
Yeah, Emac. I mean, I love these types of games when you see really good quarterback play. And the biggest stat that jumped out to me when you look at the stat sheet going into the half is there's only one sack per team. And I think that's why, you know, we're at a 21-21 game is tied up because the quarterbacks aren't, you know, being reckless with the football. There's not a lot of turnovers. You see them going to the right places. They're going through their reads. One thing I love about Sam Hartman, even last week versus Clemson, he had that look in his eye that he wasn't fearful. And I feel like that's the same that's carrying over into this week versus NC State. Some of the throws that he's making, you see here in the red zone, going through his read, delivering a great, perfect back corner, corner route right there. So I think as the game continues to flow, whichever defensive line can get after the quarterback is really going to probably come down with the victory.
You know, as I'm watching the Wolfpack, I was really surprised about how they came out and found rhythm early on. Emac, how were they able to do that in game one of their season?
JC, I was too, and really expected to see a little bit of sluggishness, not having played a game, just, again, having that elongated camp, if you will, where you're preparing for a team, then the game gets postponed, you got frustration mentally, and now you're here. So that's just great preparation by their coaching staff to do a fantastic job of getting them ready. And, again, understanding as a quarterback to take what the defense gives you. There's going to be openings, and the patience, the confidence from NC State, it's been really cool to see.
Yeah, take what the defense gives you is exactly what Christian Beal-Smith did here on this run as we take a quick break on the halftime report. Here on ACCN, bounces left. Game so nice, they named him thrice. Christian Beal-Smith, Wake Forest, NC State, tied up at 21. All right, take a look at the tail of the tape. It's a close game between the Wolfpack and the Deacons at half. Tie scored, but NC State has the edge over Wake with 40 more yards and averaging more yards per play. EJ, second half, what would you like to see from either team?
Well, I want to say the NC State offensive line is going to have to pick it up because Carlos Basham is starting to smell blood. He just got a sack to close out the second quarter. And again, like going back to what I said the segment ago, whichever defensive line gets after the quarterback, because they're both playing so well right now, is going to determine who's going to win this game. So that O-line for NC State is going to have to pick it up a little more.
DJ, I'm going with the NC State defense. They're going to have to get off the field. They were doing great, but now each offense seemingly getting whatever they want. And if I'm the NC State offense, I'm going to just try to keep doing everything the exact same. We're averaging almost 8 yards per anything, whether it's a rush or a pass. So these guys are really executing at a high level. It's going to be fun to see these adjustments made. Wake Forest, though, you are hot right now. You've scored on your last three possessions. Expect them to come out swinging. I would not be surprised if we didn't see a couple of big shots early from Sam Hartman and the Demon Deacons.
EJ, we've seen Wake Forest already in week one versus Clemson, a superior opponent. So we know a little bit about them. We didn't know anything about the Wolfpack coming in. What was your initial impression of a first half and why Wolfpack fans should maybe be optimistic for the season?
Jordan, I was impressed. I was thoroughly impressed. Honestly, I was watching the game downstairs with my dad, And we both were looking at it like, man, this quarterback is nice, talking about Hockman. You look back at the stats that he had last year, you know, they were, you know, they were good. You know, he had moments of, you know, showing what he's doing right now. And you obviously see why he was the quarterback that got the nod over Leary. And they're rolling. So I think he's going to be the guy for at NC State moving forward.
Well, it's going to be a great second half. A lot of action going on there in Raleigh. A tied score, Wake at NC State. Oh, Mr. Manuel, you want some of that quarterback that you like? There's Bailey Hockman taking it in. More from him in a second half.
That boy balling.
That boy real good.
ACC Network College Football is brought to you by GEICO. Great to have you with us tonight here from Raleigh, North Carolina. Dave O'Brien alongside Tim Hasselbeck and Katie George. An entertaining first half, Tim, 21-21. And when you look at those first half numbers, they're almost identical. They're awfully close. You know, NC State gets out to a big lead. Wake comes back. They come storming back, and they tie the ball game at 21.
It really has been all about offense, and somewhat surprising how it's come. Design quarterback run with Bailey Hockman, then a direct snap to Ricky Person. They go for the score, but not to be outdone. Wake Forest responds. Sam Hartman in the passing game. And then Christian Beal-Smith doing an excellent job of getting into the perimeter and finding a way for a score. Really impressed with both offenses so far in the first half.
A look at our Zaxby's first half statistics. 270 yards for the Pack, 231 for the Demon Deacs. And look at the passing yards, almost perfect across the board, 151 and 147. Yards per play, almost 6 yards per play for Wake and over seven for NC State. Dave Clawson's offense, they are used to getting rocking and rolling. And they finally did after falling behind by a couple of touchdowns. And we are set for the second half, and I would expect plenty more offense by both of these teams. It's the opener for NC State. Wake coming in at 0-1. And Katie George caught up with the head coach of Wake Forest, Dave Clawson.
Well, Dave Clawson said NC State, they started fast. They have a new coordinator. It's their first game. They're amped up. He felt his team was on their heels. He said that he felt that the offense started to settle in nicely after they went down 14-0. He said that was necessary. This is obviously a rivalry game. He felt some of his wide receivers made really nice catches, tough catches across the middle that would extend drives. That was very helpful. But like you said, Dave, this game is going to come down to the fourth quarter. He says we just need to hang out, hang around, and we'll be fine.
It certainly feels that way, doesn't it, Katie? And Jaquari Robertson, I think that's one guy. Robertson's the guy that he's looking at and saying, well, he made a couple of spectacular catches for him and really helped out on major drives. Now Bill Smith trying to get free of a tackler. He's going to be taken down hard, slammed on his back. A little something extra there. Peyton Wilson, who had a sack in the first half, comes up with a tackle on a running back to deny. And a flag on the play.
After the play was over, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, number 11 defense, 15-yard penalty from the previous spot, and an automatic. First down.
That's his second.
Yeah, and you see Peyton Wilson, they do a good job. They bottle up Christian Beal-Smith, got him down, good play. But it's just the lift up and body slam that you can't do that. They've taken that out of the game. And, you know, now a great play by the NC State defense turns into a 15-yard gain for the Wake offense.
Yes, totally unnecessary there. So first down and 10. As Wake Forest begins their first drive of the second half, low snap here for Hartman, but he's going to hand this off for Walker, who really had a nice first half. He will scoot on out of bounds, but he was the primary back in the first two quarters.
And you mentioned it, Dave. He was excellent in that first half, running with power, running with patience, and does the same thing there, that long ride read mesh point, and then he bounces it out, you know, to the weak side and gets a good block on the perimeter by Donald Stewart.
So they pick up a first down on the very first effort. Harmon back to throw. He's going to air that out and incomplete. Sam Hartman, very strong first half. That was intended for Morn. Broken up by Tyler Baker Williams. Second down. here for Wake. Get the first win of the season. These schools have met an in 128 year history.
Hard
hit to the sideline. And another pass broken up and a big hit on play. That was for Don Green, made a knock. He is down, hit back. In fact, both players on the play injured. So two men, one on each side. And Pat picking up Donovan Green, the intended receiver, until he's in agony. We will take a break. No, no. Here in the third, we are tied at one and run. Well, the action has been hot all night in Raleigh, and it's heating up even more so now. Two players got really nicked up on this collision moments ago, and a man still down, Tishon Smith, the left cornerback for NC State. Donovan Green has gotten up. Take a look.
And it's just an unfortunate collision. As you see, Tyler Baker Williams hits Donovan Green, and then Tayshawn Smith kind of gets the ricochet, and both guys kind of awkwardly hit and then hit the ground. And it's good to see them both standing up under their own power. And you obviously hope that both players are okay.
And Tayshawn going right into the tent there. The senior corner for NC State, Chris Ingram, was not ready to go because of a lingering injury from last year. He was their top-rated corner. They won't have him maybe next week either. Third down and 10 for Wake Forest in a 21-21 tie in Raleigh. And Hartman going deep, looking for his receiver, and going to be incomplete. Well, he wanted to get A.T. Perry, who's hit a couple of times so far tonight for big gains, but not here.
Yeah, and Sam Hartman's doing the right thing by giving his wide receiver a chance to go play the football. I think this is pass interference. I mean, Malik Dunlap's right arm grabs the shoulder of A.T. Perry as he's trying to come back to the football. The coaching point for receivers is come back through contact. Probably need to do a better job of that, but that's defensive pass interference.
No call, no flag there. Three consecutive incompletions. Thayer Thomas back to receive the punt for the Wolfpack. And what a bad punt that was. 13:57 to go here. And NC State to benefit. 21-21, our score. And Bailey Hockman really had some big moments in the first half. Left-handed quarterback was 12 for 12 during one run. For 17, 147 yards in the first half of the NC State quarterback.
Yeah, and I think that you should be able to build off of the confidence that you probably got in the first half with how the offense operated. Maybe even expect them to open up a little bit more for Bailey Hockman in the second half.
Better be able to benefit from a 5-yard punt. And a handoff for Person. He is off to the races down the left sideline before he is banged out of bounds on a huge gainer. That goes for 30.
And again, it's the left side of that offensive line just continuing to pound outside of the football. Great movement, huge hole, and starting the second half offensively the way they started the first half.
First and 10 from the 25 of Wake Forest. And be Person again. He's going to be wrapped up. Nowhere to run or hide this time as he is stacked up by Wake. Red, the first man to get to him. So Person is denied. They will give him 3 yards. So second and 7 coming up. Person along with Bam Knight and Jordan Houston. Really a fine running back room for NC State. They're on the march again here in the second half of play in Raleigh. And Hockman on second down and seven. And another handoff, and once again the running back Person gets free, bouncing outside, diving for the pylon, and just short. They're going to mark it just short at around the 1 yard line. He gained 21.
Wake Forest playing with two high safeties, and they do a good job of running the football. North Carolina State does. Person's got to be careful here. That ball comes out, and it's fortunate it did not go into the end zone. Obviously, that'd be a touchback for Wake Forest. But more and more you see players want to reach for that goal line as they get close. But so the best coaching point is continue to keep that high and tight. You get knocked out at the one, it's all right. You got first and goal from the one. North Carolina State catches a break there.
NC State trying to bang it in again. And instead, Wake Forest rises up and drives him back. So nothing doing for Person. He will lose ground. He loses a yard.
Yeah, it's the same play they ran earlier where they motioned Bailey Hockman out of the formation, direct snap to the running back. But ultimately, you know, we've seen North Carolina State do that a couple times tonight, repeat a play, maybe because, you know, they're trying to keep it simple offensively. Wake Forest hasn't been fooled the second time.
Second and goal, right to Person. He's going to throw it over the top, and it's going to be hauled in. And a touchdown. There is a flag down on the play. Ricky Person becomes a quarterback. But a flag down.
Pass interference. Number six, defense. Penalties declined. Result of the play is a touchdown.
A touchdown. And how about this effort by Ricky Person, who did a little bit of everything on that drive, including a touchdown pass.
Yeah, and I maybe misspoke. Tim Beck setting it up, motions the quarterback out of the formation again, and then it's the Tebow jump pass off of the direct snap look. And you know, the creativity again that we are seeing, the diversity of plays offensively, been really impressive.
Devin Carter hauling it in, and the extra point is good. 28-21.
Well, there's that Urban Meyer, Tim Tebow influence. But this time it's Ricky Person as the quarterback with the jump pass to put NC State back on top.
This week, college football is coming together to recognize the impactful work of great teachers and the way they've been performing their essential duties against extraordinary backdrops of the COVID-19 pandemic. On behalf of the College Football Playoff Foundation and ESPN, we'd like to honor teachers and their goal to keep kids learning. We have a $1,000 Donors Choose gift card that can be used towards school resources. And tonight, we're sending this to Anne Marie Johnson, a special needs teacher at Scotts Ridge Elementary School in Apex, North Carolina, who does spectacular work. And for more on this, let's go down to Katie George.
Well, Anne Marie Johnson said she was shocked when she heard the news that she would receive $1,000 to help the students at her school. She told me the money will be used to purchase sensory-seeking kits. Many of her students need pressure to help calm their bodies down in moments of frustration or uncertainty. So think weighted blankets, weighted pads for children's laps to make them feel grounded. She really seems thrilled to be able to supply more items like this for her school, and congratulations to her.
Indeed, and that $1,000 Donors Choose gift card, that's going to go a long, long way. And congratulations, Anne Marie Johnson. First down and 10 here for Wake Forest, trying to answer now. NC State with a spectacular touchdown moments ago, as we see a little bit of everything by these offenses. And a jump pass by a running back to a wide receiver to put them up 28-21.
Yeah, that's what I mean about the diversity of the offensive play calls.
Pressure here, collapsing on the quarterback, and Hartman could not get free, and they're getting a little bit frisky.
Sam Hartman just forced to hold on to the football, wasn't comfortable finding anywhere to go with it. And Christian Beale Smith, who's doing a pretty good job in pass protection, that's a long time to hold up on a corner that's coming off the edge, and they're eventually able to get to Hartman.
Play loses eight, bringing a third down and 18 for Wake Forest. And Hartman again from the shotgun. wants to throw deep, looking for a receiver, and that play is broken up. On the long, long pass, good job there by Dunlap again, covering Donovan Green.
Yeah, and this would have been a brutal conversion for NC State's defense. They've already given up a couple third and longs. It's good defense by Dunlap. Donovan Green, this is what they expect their wide receivers to do in Wake Forest. These big 6'2", 6'3" wide receivers go up and fight for these footballs on contested throws. Not able to come down with that one.
So the last six Wake Forest plays have lost 8 yards total. And they are forced to punt again here to the Wolfpack. That's going to bounce out around the 50-yard line. Let's toss it down for an update to Katie George.
Well, guys, I spoke with Wake Forest athletic trainer Chris Hanks. He said Donovan Green is good to go. He bruised that lower back during the collision with Tayshaun Smith. But after that missed catch right there that we saw, he was grimacing and slow to get up. As he came over to the sideline, he threw his helmet, and his head is still down in his hands currently here on the sidelines. So he's visibly in pain, something to keep an eye on as we move forward.
He's been a key target tonight. Obviously was moments ago when they went for the big gainer. That, by the way, was the first three and out for either team so far tonight. An indication of how these offenses have been cooking. 10.5 minutes to go in the third in Raleigh. So NC State and Bailey Hockman taking over. Up by 7. He's back to pass again. And now he'll step up. He's done this a number of times and picks up a nice gain. Takes a knock, but you know this is not supposed to be a major part of his game, but he picks up 12 here, Tim.
Well, he does pick up 12 here, and not known as a runner, but this is great awareness. Clock in his head. Doesn't like it downfield. Be decisive. Take off and run. And he's doing an excellent job of, when he does run, of taking care of the football. So good decision there by Bailey Hockman. That's one of the things the coaches pointed at coming into the game as a starter, the decisions at the position.
Most in an ACC game, those 28 points since November 24 of 18, and a gain outside, finally shoved out, is Bam Knight. Basham got to him, but not before he gets it to the red zone. That's a gain of 20.
NC State's ability to get to the perimeter on these runs has been a real testament to these backs. Their patience, then their ability to bounce it, and then they're benefiting from guys blocking downfield.
New offensive coordinator Tim Beck at the controls tonight for NC State. First year with the program, and he has a lot of it clicking. And another run here for Knight as he is tripped up and taken down by Bergen. That's a gain of 3 yards for the Wolfpack.
You know, we knew we'd see a lot of this run game, Dave, but can't say that I was expecting to see 6 20-plus-yard runs. I mean, that's what everybody's looking for in the run game. It's amazing to get 6 of them in one night.
Hockman trying to get them into the end zone again. Second down and 8, looking downfield. Throws into the end zone and a touchdown. They go to the tight end, Angeline, and he hauls it in for 6 points. That's a 15-yard touchdown pass.
Well, you get chunk plays in the run game. You're running the football, sticking to the belly of the back. Look at the linebackers step up, which allows your big 6'7" tight end, Gary Angeline, to run down the middle of the field. Good timing of the play call by Tim Beck. Great execution by this Wolfpack offense.
Angeline, a hefty target at 6'7", 250 out of Chester Springs, Pennsylvania. And the extra point is good. So NC State widens it out 35-21 here in the ACC tonight over Wake Forest.
When you think about the struggles of NC State offensively a year ago, they seem to have completely gone away. As you see what they've done the last two drives in this second half, you think about 4 for 4 in the red zone in terms of coming away with touchdowns, something that they were terrible at doing a year ago. Really just an offensive display of fireworks so far by the Wolfpack.
I was playing around with the idea of asking you about a left-handed quarterback, and does it take a little extra time to get used to a lefty? Well, they've taken absolutely no time getting used to Bailey Hawkman, who has been in complete command of this thing tonight.
Well, it is a real thing, you know, as a play caller calling plays for a left-hander, how you roll them out. It is for a receiver. The spin on the ball is different. Right. They seem to be just A-OK with it.
Yeah. Well, Wake Forest is missing 9 offensive starters from a team that started last year 7-1, lost 4 of their last 5, but got the 8 wins. Newman announced that grad transfer to Georgia, and then he opted out. Sage Surratt, one of the great receivers in the country, opted out as well. They would lose their opener 37-13. But tonight, are you noticing some cracks where these players that they had a year ago, Tim, would have filled in?
Well, offensively, I've been impressed with them, but there is no doubt they lost a ton of production and lost some really good players.
Hartman's going to go down in a heap as he'll take the sack. Daniel Joseph all over him, and he's been his best friend a couple of times tonight.
Yeah, and Dave, we've seen this Wake Forest team. We saw them three times last year, and those were good players. And Dave Clawson told us he really benefits from developing his players and getting them to their fifth year and getting their best year of football at the end of their time at Wake Forest. And so, yeah, the opt-out by Sage Surratt, the transfer by Jamie Newman, no doubt had to be, you know, something that on top of everything you're dealing with in terms of the virus and how it can affect your football team, it makes it really difficult.
Gain of 13. Hartman back to throw again. Some pressure coming on him, and he will air it out incomplete. So production lost from 2019 just from the receiving core. And it wasn't just Surratt who was just brilliant out there, but Scotty Washington, a reliable target. Kendall Hinton last year, over 1,000 yards and 4 touchdowns. And guys who were a big, big part of it. And another sack. He goes down again. And guess who? It's Peyton Wilson, who's having a big night.
Yeah, he's having a big night, coming off the edge here. A little confusion by Chapman, the tight end. Not sure that he should be blocking him. And it's kind of interesting. This is an area of the field where that student section at NC State would start to create some noise and become a problem. Now it's just the defense doing it by itself.
And another incomplete pass. NC State has given up 4 sacks. I should say they have sacked the quarterback 4 times tonight. Tayshaun Smith, who's back in there and defending the receiver that was intended for Donald Stewart. 7:37 to go here, and 4th down and 12, they will punt it.
And it has to feel like it's uphill right now for that Wake offense after the 3-and-out, first one of the night last series. Obviously the struggles there, going backwards again. But remember, they did start out down 14 to start the football game and responded. Would not be surprised to see them come back with some type of response.
It'll let this one bounce. And so at 35-21, NC State taking command of the game, but plenty of time here in the third quarter. Wake has been a quick strike team as well.
You know what's up. Better check the scoring numbers going up.
Bailey Hawkman getting the opportunity to start for NC State, taking advantage of that opportunity as a design runner down in the red zone, scrambling on design pass plays, and then just dropping dimes when he needs to in the red zone. What a night so far by Bailey Hawkman.
Houston with the carry on 1st down and 10. He gets stacked up. Well, Hawkman making his 3rd career start, but looking like someone who's been under center for, you know, 25 or 30 starts, the way he's performed tonight. And surprising Wake with his ability to scramble. And he's going to get picked off. Intercepted by Wake Forest. And Taylor goes into the end zone. Yes, sir. Taylor all the way in for the pick 6. And a touchdown, Wake Forest. And defensively, a giant play in this one.
I think it's just a great play by Taylor. Hawkman is on time. And Taylor's just able to jump the route.
An interception and a return 45 yards for a touchdown. The first turnover of this game. And the extra point is good. 35-28 NC State. So just when it appeared that they were building a safe enough lead, at least for, you know, midway through the third quarter, here comes Wake again with the turnover.
And Bailey Huckman is trying to just work outside.
And I did get the run back.
Throwing a comeback outside. You just look at Taylor. Looks like quarters coverage. And it's just a great job of Taylor driving on the route, stepping inside of the wide receiver. And Hawkman probably could miss outside a little bit more. But that's just an outstanding defensive play. Let you see it, Taylor.
So Hawkman with the mistake defensively. They capitalize on Hawkman with the defense of Wake Forest. And it's 35-28 with 6:53 to go. Wake was able to bounce back after getting themselves in a pretty good hole in the first half and tie it at 21-21. And now the Demon Deacons coming back and ready to kick off here with Person and Engel back to receive for NC State. Person weaving past the 30-yard line before he's taken down. Well, Tim, you give it up like that, you throw the pick. They bring it all the way back 45 yards for a touchdown, and you've got to shake it off just as quickly.
You absolutely do, and it's one of the things you don't really know how somebody's going to respond to it. As you see Tim Beck, the offensive coordinator, with his hand around the quarterback's shoulder saying, hey, look, we're all right. You're having a great night. You can't let one throw get you down or get you into a funk. And so, yeah, you need to just move on, kind of press that erase button and continue to play the way you had been playing throughout the night.
Well, first and 10, another carry for Jordan Houston. And he'll gain 3 yards for NC State to bring up the second down and 7.
And I do think as these coaches learn about their players, this is a great opportunity for them to learn about Bailey Hawkman and how he'll respond to adversity.
Well, before that rush, NC State had 215 yards in rushing so far tonight. And again, it's Jordan Houston with the carry for 3. So third down and 4. For the longest part of this game, everybody was converting on third down. NC State still 6 out of 8 from the gun. And a handoff again. Houston trying to follow his blockers and diving ahead. And another tough run from Houston. Taken down by A.J. Williams. Gain of 1. So fourth down and 3.
With Jordan Houston in the backfield, it seemed like Wake Forest like to have an A.J. Williams playing, kind of playing outside linebacker. He's listed at 195 pounds, but just getting extra speed on the field. The North Carolina State is playing with a speed back.
Fourth and 3, forced into punting it. Only their second punt of the ball game. Morin elects to take it. Here it comes. Heading for the 30 before he is pushed out of bounds. Taylor Morin, receiver and punt returner. We take a look at our big bowl moment of tonight's game.
Well, that would be an obvious one. It's the pick 6 by Jasir Taylor. It's just an excellent job of reading the quarterback, trusting your instincts, and driving on the football. time when it seemed like NC State might have an opportunity to pull away. Huge stop in swing of events by that defense of Wake Forest. And, you know, defensively, you know, a fair amount of guys back and had experience from a year ago. I do think that Dave Clawson does think he's better on that side of the ball.
Last three drives, they haven't done anything, but they're going to get a big gain right here. Christian Beal-Smith finally taken down after a gain of 31 yards and a first down.
Yeah, a lot of teams run zone read. They run it on the perimeter, but you look at the way Wake Forest does it, they run it right over the center. They ask a lot of their center, does a good job there getting movement, and that allows Christian Beal-Smith to rip off a nice run.
Wake's biggest gain of the ball game, 31 yards by Christian Beal-Smith. And they're going to run it again, bouncing outside for Beal-Smith, and he's becoming the workhorse here. Taken down by Peyton Wilson, but he picks up 5 yards.
Watching these teams that go with tempo, you need more than one back because you're going so fast that you know, it's easy to get tired. You know, as you're running, and especially with the way they read some of these things, you need two backs. Both teams have more than that.
Hartman hands off again, right into the center of the pile, but can't move it. Christian Beal-Smith with a carry. He lost a yard there. And Hartman was calling to the bench immediately. Sam Hartman, the quarterback, when he went down. Beal-Smith now in a seated posture, but he's hurt. And we'll find out how badly. So 3:48 to go here in the third.
Yeah, he may just be tapping his head saying he's tired. I know he's tired. Sometimes as a quarterback, you can tell when guys are gassed. You know, you just standing next to them, you're hearing them breathe. They're maybe telling you to slow down, even though you know the sideline is telling you to speed up.
Yeah, and in fact, it might not even be an injury. You just need a breather.
I mean, it just, when you think about the pace, you think about, you know, how the offseason, you know, was different. I mean, guys were home instead of training in their strength program. And, you know, training camps were different. And, you know, starters aren't getting all the reps. Sometimes it's, you know, the backups getting reps because they may need to play. And so there's so many factors that could play into it. It's good to see Christian Beal-Smith going off on his own power.
Yeah, he's been fun to watch tonight. Here at Carter-Finley Stadium in Raleigh, North Carolina, ACC Network football, NC State against Wake Forest. Dave O'Brien with the pride of Boston College, Tim Hasselbeck, and the pride of Louisville, Katie George. I went to Syracuse. Under 3:40 to go in the third.
They're proud of you, Dave.
I hope so. I hope somebody is. Going to be forced back once again. So nothing doing on that carry. Walker had an excellent first half. Daniel Joseph come up to say hello. Fourth down and 5. And from the 35, they're going to go for it here. Hartman again out of the shotgun. Looking to throw. Throwing short over the middle. They're going to pick it up. And a nice grab there by Roberson, who was such an effective target in the first half. That picks up 9.
North Carolina State decides to heat Wake Forest up. You see the blitz coming off to the right. Hartman does a great job of playing on time. Ball right to the face mask of Roberson. That's good quarterback play, and it's a nice route in anticipation by Roberson,
who has made 6 catches. Walker looking to bounce outside, but they string him out before he is out of bounds. He did gain 2 very tough yards before Harris got him. 35-28 NC State. About 2.5 to go in the third. Wake trying to punch it in again. Last time they scored, it was the defense on a pick 6 that got them into the end zone. Second down 8. Barker trying to go wide again. Wilson there to make the tackle.
So Peyton Wilson, you know, at 6'4", 240, he moves so well for a linebacker of that size, side to side. I mean, just a freak physically. Seen him with a personal foul. We've also seen him with the sacks, made a few big plays tonight.
He really has played exceptionally well on the defensive side. Cardinal will fire, and that one complete. Caught again by Roberson on that route along the side.
Roberson working in the slot again. He's just going to run an out cut, and you see the timing. Good timing on the sideline there by Hartman to get the ball out. Not a lot of room as you're working into the boundary.
Now another man down here for NC State. Terrell Dawkins with a minute 43 showing on the clock. With first and 10 coming up, well, college football continues next weekend on ACC Network. Another triple header at noon. Good one here. Number 18, Louisville against number 25, Pitt. Then it's Duke and Virginia at 4. And NC State, number 20, Virginia Tech at 8 p.m. ACC Network football next Saturday beginning at noon Eastern on the ACC Network. How many games for you this week, Tim? It's usually at least two or three.
Pared it down, Dave. Just a one football game this week. But it is nice seeing
one.
Just the one. It is nice seeing a full slate of ACC games, isn't it? Doesn't it feel good?
For you, it's like see them all in one week. But by the way, Miami, after three, leading Louisville 37-20. And we saw the Hurricanes and a brand new quarterback and a new approach, a new offense in week number one. And a lot of it seemed to click, and it's clicking again tonight.
Yeah, they were a lot of fun to watch. And, you know, it's one of the things that's exciting about the ACC this year is so many good quarterbacks in the conference.
Now, first down and 10. Been a number of low snaps tonight that Hartman has handled. It opens up for Walker off the right side, and he's going to rumble on in for a touchdown. Wake Forest just keeps on coming back. That's a 13-yard touchdown run for Walker.
They keep coming back, and it's the offensive line up front. I mean, just everybody moving together, pushing left, and then a great job of Walker. You've said it a number of times tonight, Dave. Good patience as a runner. He sees the cutback lane. That's just good offensive football.
And he has carried 18 times tonight for 94 yards and now two touchdowns. And this game is tied. 35-35.
Look at the movement off of the ball by the offensive line. Just pushing left, as you can see here. You see that push left, the movement, playing on the other side of the line of scrimmage, and then the cutback. There it is, and it's a good job backside by Nash, the right tackle. But look at the movement. Look where the line of scrimmage gets pushed. And look, that's not down in two-hand touch. That's a great job of the guys up front getting movement, the back pressing the hole, and then having that patience that you've talked about, Dave, and he gets backside.
Kenneth Walker, the sophomore, with his second touchdown, and he's closing in on 100 yards already. So Jack Crane to kick off in a tie ball game. And turning into a dandy here in Raleigh on the ACC Network. And they will bring it out to the 25. Wake Forest has never led, and they have trailed by 14 points on three occasions. A flag down.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking tee. By rule, the ball 35-yard line. First down.
Went out of bounds, so up to the 35-yard line. You know, three different occasions down by 14, and they've rallied every time.
I mean, just a second ago, it felt like they were down 14. It was like, wait, is it again? Here they go again. And sure enough, the response on defense. And then, you know, you can come away with six defensively, get an opportunity to make some plays. And I'm just impressed with the mental toughness of this Wake group to continue to punch back.
Minute 24 before the fourth quarter gets underway. Bailey Hawkman will sling that one to the sideline. But it's going to be incomplete. Second down and 10. He is 14 for 19, 162 yards, and a very costly interception. So this is setting up a dandy of a fourth quarter. NC State, their first game of the season. Hawkman flushed out of there, tosses that one up, and again, it is going to be incomplete.
It's interesting. I originally thought that Collins was able to get his feet in. Looks like that right foot is on the line, even though he was dragging his left foot. And the officials got that one right by rolling it out of bounds.
Third and 10. Ricky Person, a running back. And Hawkman shovels that one ahead. Person took a pretty good hit there. He was stuck by Smenda. Ryan Smenda came up and met him.
Yeah, and since the interception, obviously not a lot going. They try to sneak something by Wake Forest with a little shovel pass, but it's now 2-3 and out since the interception. I've referenced, you know, how do you respond after a critical error? And you know, so far, the NC State offense has not been able to respond since that critical error.
Taylor Morn back to receive the punt from Trenton Gill. Both special teams very strong. Gets free of a tackler. He's still up, still on his feet. He's got a little room to operate, cutting it back inside and tripped up from behind, shy of the 40-yard line. Otherwise, he may have been off to the races. That was a 50-yard punt and a 24-yard return.
I feel like this is good football all the way around. What a return by Taylor Morin. You just see him here, just the quickness, the ability to stay on his feet, and then watch Peyton Wilson, who, by the way, misses the tackle earlier but continues to hustle and potentially saves a touchdown by pursuing, you know, the kicking game, a big issue for Wake Forest a year ago. And that's a nice play in the kicking game by their return team.
That's a key man down. That is Peyton Wilson. We've called his name a lot tonight. And maybe cramping up. Let's go to Katie George.
Well, guys, NC State defensive end Savion Jackson made a joke of sorts over here on the sidelines. He said, man, I didn't even have a chance to get a drink of water. And you guys have talked about the speed and the pace that these two teams are playing with. When Bailey Hawkman and the offense can't extend a drive, the guys over here on the defensive side are not getting a break that they need going here into late into the fourth quarter.
Yeah, it's been that way since Jump Street tonight with the pace of the offenses. And no huddles. But right now, the best starting field position for Wake Forest of any drive tonight with 21 seconds to go in the third.
You have to think. I mean, you talked about it at the open of the game. You shut down training camp for 8 days. You know, typically, you know, you just continue to build on your team's conditioning during training camp, but you're worried about trying to keep guys healthy and get guys, you're not sure who's going to practice. It's hard to do that.
Up trying to right side and a scuffle for the football, and NC State says they have it. And they're claiming a turnover here, and Aleem McNeil. And now they'll try and sort this out. With 12 seconds to go in the third, NC State convinced that there had been a turnover on the play. And that is going to be the case. The Wolfpack
on the field with the
get the turnover.
By the defense. First down.
Bill Smith just goes inside there.
Really on the previous play of a fumble recovered by the defense is under further review.
All right, so they're going to take a look at this. It's the first takeaway for NC State. You can see it there on that replay.
does seem that Beal Smith is going to the ground, and he kind of has a reaction that he's looking for the football, like he knows that it's out.
Right.
And McNeil, who goes about 320, he's just strong enough to pry it out of there.
Yeah, he squats about 640. And in on the scrum and came away with the football. You could see it right there for a split second. You could see it was out.
And because of how it was ruled, and you really can't see Christian Beal Smith's knee if it happened to be on the ground or not, because of the way it was ruled on the field, and because you're not going to get an angle to see if he was down before that ball came out, I think this ends up being confirmed. You know, McNeil's a critical player when you're playing a team like Wake Forest, because, you know, Wake will ask the center to single block somebody. And because of that long mesh point, it takes a while.
I'm going to give you two final looks here. With 12 seconds to go in the third, ruled on the field a fumble by Wake Forest, recovered by NC State.
And see here, it seems like Beal Smith's kind of on top.
After
of some
further
players.
Review, the ruling on the field stands.
Well, you were correct, Tim. There was no other evidence to overturn that. So last three NC State drives have been 8 plays, 10 yards, interception, punt, punt. But now looking to do more here in the final seconds of this quarter. Hockman's going to hand off for Knight. Knight finding room to operate down to the 20-yard line. Bam Knight with a big carry. So he picks up a first down, and that's the end of the third. And Wake Forest has won 3 in a row over NC State for the first time in a long time. This has turned into a dandy in the second half in Raleigh. ECC Network Primetime Football presented by Geico. And this should be a whole lot of fun as we hit the fourth quarter. Wake Forest 35, NC State 35. NC State likes to call themselves Quarterback U. They've got 5 NFL former NC State quarterbacks right now who are on National Football League rosters. So the running play on the handoff to Knight, and he'll pick up 5 yards to get the fourth quarter started.
And those quarterbacks that are sitting in the stands accomplish a lot here at NC State. Obviously, Bailey Hockman getting something going here tonight.
Hand off again, it's Knight, but no room to operate. First man to meet him was Miles Fox.
And it's a good job of Miles Fox creating a little bit of penetration. See there, just pushing the offensive lineman back into the backfield. And I would really expect Tim Beck to come up with something creative here. The quarterback, you know, he started off hot, has struggled the last couple drives. Try to come up with an easy completion that can still get you the first down on 3rd and 6.
From inside the 15-yard line and driving. Not a running play, though. And this time, Ricky Person is taken down. Basham there. He's the man who read it and erased him.
Yeah, an interesting call. You know, I'm talking about getting creative. And I think they just decided to see if they could run for it. But 3rd and 6, down in tight. A little bit surprised that they didn't, you know, do something a little bit more creative to try to pick up the first down.
Well, Christopher Dunn has made 11 in a row. This one is up, and this one is good. So Dunn, who's one of the best around, number 5 in school history, has put NC State in front 38-35. So the Wolfpack has forged in front. First time anyone's had to do that tonight, because a touchdown has been the watchword.
it does make you feel a little bit funny. This is me anyway, looking at it saying, I don't know the field goals will get it done, right? Reminiscent of the Louisville Wake Forest game that we had last year that ended up 62-59.
Yeah, I think we're still counting those.
Yeah, so much offense, and you see there just, you know, settling for three. And you see the way that both offenses have scored points tonight, doesn't exactly give you a ton of confidence that that will get it done.
So NC State to kick. And Trenton Gill. And another flag there. So just getting underway here in the fourth. 13-19 to go, and a 3-point lead for the Wolfpack.
You know, and even though Sam Hartman has some experience.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking tee. By rule, the ball is placed to the 35-yard line. First down.
You can't replicate these situations where, you know, you feel like you're playing well, and, you know, sure enough, you just find yourself in a situation where, you know, you've got to go toe-to-toe in the fourth quarter.
So, 3-point lead here for the Wolfpack early in the fourth. And Wake is going to throw it again, and a completed pass nudged out of bounds is A.T. Perry. So he'll gain 7 yards on the first play. So we'll see which quarterback will lead his team to victory tonight. Both really interesting stories of the QBs coming into play. Walker gets free of one man. He slipped one tackle, slips another tackle. Boy, he's been so cagey tonight. And he picks up 14 on that carry.
And you've referenced his patience, but how about just the speed and desire to just, hey, I'm going to hit the hole hard this time, and I'm going to outrun the angle of Peyton Wilson, who's been all over the field, tracking me down. It's a really nice run by Kenneth Walker.
So he has 108 yards now, and he has scored 2 touchdowns. 3-point game. Walker again, but not much room to operate in the center of that line here. Calvin Hart with the tackle, and he picked up just 1 yard. Second down and 9. Coming up on 12 minutes to go. Back to throw Hartman, and a completed pass. That one caught by Stewart, who a couple of times tonight has made big plays here for Wake Forest, tackled by Drake Thomas.
Yeah, Stewart's running an in cut, and it's really nice timing by Sam Hartman. Hit him as he's coming into that break to allow for a little run after the catch.
So first down, first and 10 for Hartman. It's Walker again. Walker cutting back inside. So a decent gain there. Another pretty good carry by Kenneth Walker, taken down by Thomas. He'll gain 4 yards. Second down.
Just watching the pursuit of the North Carolina State defense, I do feel like they are getting worn down and are tired.
Hartman, pedal to the metal here, but that one, a flag on the play. On the incomplete pass.
Pass interference, number 4, defense, automatic, first down.
At the top of the route, Cecil Collins has probably got enough of the jersey. And I think because of the way that A.T. Perry goes down, that probably makes it look a little more egregious than it was.
Yeah, pretty good sales job by Perry there.
Well, listen, that helps. As an offensive guy, you're looking for that kind of help from your wide receiver.
Not to say it was not pass interference. 11:13 left here in the fourth quarter. And NC State with a slender lead against a Wake Forest program they are meeting for the 114th time. NC State and Wake have met more than any other opponent in the 128-year football history of the two. Walker again. Walker takes another hit and keeps on running, taken down by Drake Thomas. He'll gain 4 yards on that carry.
Yeah, Walker continues to run hard, and it's his speed as this game has gone along. You're just outrunning angles, and that looked like, you know, the potential to be bottled up. Still the ability to get to the edge and pick up positive yards.
5'10 sophomore having a big, big night. Stewart, the man in motion. Quarterback's going to roll out. Hartman trying to throw now and completes another pass. Blake Whitehart, his tight end, with that reception before he was stopped by Baker Williams.
Yeah, it was a unique formation. Wake Forest ran it 2 times in a row. The first time they ran it to the left with Kenneth Walker. Then it was the play action coming off of it. North Carolina State wasn't fooled, but Sam Hartman does a nice job of just navigating the pocket, being able to avoid the defender and get the football off.
5 yard gain, so it's 3rd and 1. Nose of the football right to the 10 yard line. And again, that mesh offense, and it's Walker again. He will dive ahead and he will pick up the first down. He gains 3. So here come the Demon Deacons once again.
It's that mesh offense, but just look at where, like, look who's winning the line of scrimmage. That Wake Forest offensive line is getting so much movement.
Running clock inside, 9.5 minutes to go here in Raleigh. He's going to step back, throw to the end zone, and it's broken up. But there is a flag down. Flag dropped in the end zone. So Hartman going for the touchdown strike, broken up, but a flag with 9:17 to go.
Pass interference. Number 6, defense. By rule, 2-yard line and an automatic first down.
Pass interference on Harris, the strong safety.
I believe this was an RPO again. You see the penetration of the backfield. It's why Hartman pulls it out, tries to hit Chapman, and clearly there's a lot of contact as Chapman's running down the seam.
Let's get out to Katie.
Well, Dave Dorn is losing it over here. He thinks that it was an illegal man downfield with an offensive lineman in the end zone. He thinks it should have been a call for them.
And that one snapped. Here comes the run again, and jumping into the end zone, Walker for the touchdown. Well, he's been dominating this game, and he gets in for 6. Well, I can tell you on Katie's hit, you could hear Dave Doran just going ballistic on that microphone.
And that's the issue with the run pass options, is when officials don't call guys downfield, it makes it so hard to play any type of pass defense. That's why Dave Dorn was so upset. And so, yeah, they're calling for pass interference, but if you have linemen downfield, it's hard to do that. And I think that was as expected. Get down in tight. You had to think that Dave Clawson was going to get his team back to that Wildcat look.
42-38, Wake Forest has surged into the lead. Well, one sideline is still livid. That would be NC State, but Wake Forest has their first lead of this game at 42-38 with just over 9 minutes to go in Raleigh, North Carolina. And Wake to kick it off with a 4-point advantage. And we'll show you the play that Dave Doran was so angry about.
Yeah, and I can see what he saw at the end of the play, but truthfully, it's not the legal man downfield. But as you see 59 blocking into the end zone, that's probably what Dave Doran sees. He sees the ball thrown into the end zone and the right guard blocking into the end zone. But when the ball was released, there was no man downfield. And then it's into that Wildcat look. good job of sustaining blocks up front. Kenneth Walker with the good vision. So, look, on RPOs, you get guys downfield all the time. It did not happen there, even though it did look like it at the end of the play.
Meanwhile, Kenneth Walker had only four career touchdowns coming into play tonight. He has three in this game as he is turning into a star for Wake Forest. And on the big carry, Hockman is knocked down. He's been very effective with his legs tonight. Gains five here.
He is, and it's a good way to restart your quarterback if he's struggling a little bit in the passing game since the interception, is restart him, get him back into some type of rhythm as a runner.
Second down, five here for the Wolfpack in their home opener. Desperate for a win, and a big hole opens up here for Houston, who is taken down from behind. Jordan Houston with a massive carry. Basham with a tackle, 21 yards.
And a massive carry because he has a massive hole. Again, it's that left side of the line. Great push. Just his own block. Elephants on parade, they say. Everyone moving together on that offensive line to the left. Put your foot in the ground and get up the field. That was well blocked.
Nasir Greer, he's the man who's down. And it looks like he is in some pain. It will be first down when we come back. 8:36 to go. We're in the fourth quarter.
ACC Network Primetime Football is presented by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Carter-Finley Stadium in Raleigh, North Carolina. The facilities at the athletic department and all over NC State will really blow you away. And we always love coming down to Raleigh. Of course, very different circumstances here. Some of the parents are allowed for this particular game between Wake and NC State. There are about 100 of them here. About 350 people actually allowed in the stands today for this game. About 8.5 minutes to go now. Wake on top, 42-38. And they're going to throw again and hit the tight end. Imezi is forced out of bounds with 8:20 to go in this contest.
And you know, the looks of that play, Dave, it would not surprise me if they were setting up some type of double pass.
Houston again trying to slice inside before he's taken down. Stopped by Kamara. And a gain of six. To pick up the first down. NC State has had 10 plays of 20 or more yards in this one. Seven runs and three passes that have gone for big, big gains.
Yeah, and they've been creative by design. It hasn't been, you know, bust necessarily by the defense, but creative offense that has led to some of that, and as well as things being well blocked up front.
Nothing outside there for Jordan Houston. So the clock running, 7.5 to play. And inside the 40-yard line of Wake Forest, NC State trying to push it in again. This drive, five runs, then they have not passed the football. Hockman will dump this one. Van Knight on the run, getting a block. Out he goes.
They did set up the screen. They motion Imezi to the left side, kind of pump it to him like they're trying to get it to the perimeter, and they run the slow screen. Tonight, it's a good job of the guys up front. Gibson hustling downfield. It's a nice play call in that situation.
Net gains 27 yards. First and 10 for NC State. And big time substitutions now for Wake. First down for Bailey Hockman. And a timeout. And we'll take it as well.
NC State, their first of the half.
NC State with their first of the half. 42-38, Wake Forest. Now Bailey Hockman, NC State, has completed 16 passes to 9 different receivers tonight.
You called it early with the way he was spreading it out. By the way, on top of that, he's run the ball effectively this evening.
Sure has. First and 10. And a knocking on the door again. Down by 4 points here in the fourth quarter. And Hockman with the handoff, trying to bounce outside. It's Person. Person following a blocker. Getting inside the 5-yard line. So Ricky Person with the carry for 8 yards. And second down coming up.
When you look at some of these runs here, it's just a good job of the guys on the perimeter, which allow some of these slow developing runs to end up getting positive yardage. That's a 9-yard gain down in the red zone. Fair Thomas blocking on the perimeter.
Hockman running the offense. Another handoff. It's Person who dives into the end zone. He is in for the touchdown. Ricky Person, the junior out of Wake Forest, North Carolina. He goes jumping into the end zone, and they're on the board again. He has 99 yards, 2 touchdowns tonight.
Well, we knew they have a stable of backs. We've seen Jordan Houston and Bam Knight, Ricky Person again. As you said, second one of the night, just power football. 2 runs in a row to punch it in.
Done on for the PAT. And it's up and good. Back and forth we go here. And with 5:51 to go in the fourth, it's NC State in front, 45-42.
I mean, do not look away, because you are going to miss offense if you do. I mean, I just get the feeling that both of these defenses are tired. And if the offenses can just kind of keep it together a little bit, I mean, there are plays to be had. Both quarterbacks playing well. Both teams' offensive lines playing well. And running backs running on a mission.
8 plays, 7 runs on that drive. So staying on the ground. It was a very, very busy day and night in the ACC. This is one of the cappers, and NC State has the lead. Do they have enough as they're about to kick off? And give it back to Wake Forest. And back to their fine quarterback, Sam Hartman. And he's getting a great night out of his key running back, Kenneth Walker, who is well over 100 yards in this game. And off into the end zone it goes, so it'll come out to the 25. Now we go around the league, around the ACC. Pitt with a big win today against Syracuse. UCF holding off Georgia Tech 49-21. Clemson rolling 49-zip over the Citadel. Boston College downing Duke 26-6. That's why Tim has been smiling so broadly tonight. Notre Dame 52-0 over South Florida. And the other game is in the fourth quarter. Miami rolling up by 20 on Louisville.
That might be the most surprising one to see the way they're rolling. Louisville, pretty good offense of their own.
About 4 minutes left in that game. A little less than 6 in this one. Reversing course once again. It's Walker as he's tied up. Kenneth Walker has been the man, taken down by Drake Thomas after a gain of 2. So Beal Smith, the primary running back. Hartman's going to throw this time, and a completed pass. He shot that one to A.T. Perry for the game.
Good timing by Sam Hartman, because it's a small window. As you see, Isaiah Moore just hustling over there. Big collision, but a nice job by A.T. Perry holding on to the football.
First down, first and 10 on a 9-yard pickup. Hartman a handoff for Walker once again into the line and makes a couple more yards out of that as he gains 3. The pace has been absolutely furious from the very first series tonight. And it's been both sides. Hartman's going to roll right. He's going to fire and incomplete. Intended for Roberson, who in the first half was the number one target over and over again, wasn't he?
He really was. And Roberson's a guy they like to move around. We'll play outside, but you find him in the slot quite a bit. And Dave Clawson's offenses, they've always done a nice job of getting a lot of production out of the slot. They identify and kind of recruit players that fit in that role. And we've seen Roberson as well as Marin in that spot tonight.
Now Dave Clawson losing so many offensive starters and so many great players from a bowl team a year ago. A little bit of a surprising play call here. Very conservative as Hartman gets tied up, and that's going to bring up fourth down.
And that looked like the first kind of design quarterback run of the night. That looked like almost a quarterback lead. Maybe the desire was to just get into a more manageable fourth down.
So Hartman needs to make a big play on fourth and five. With 4:22 remaining here in the fourth, and NC State is going to call a timeout. We'll take the break and be back in Raleigh. Pretty good chess match between Dave Doran and Dave Clawson here. Tim, you said during the commercial break you're expecting a hard count here.
Yeah, I think you have to. I mean, for the five, you're going to be up at the line of scrimmage. Some defensive players have been known to make a mistake here or there. And so, yeah, I think absolutely you get some type of hard count. But also hopefully have a play call that you really like.
They are 2-for-2, Wake Forest is, on fourth down conversions. Harmon back to throw over the middle, and it's broken up. And incomplete. And a huge defensive stop here for the Wolfpack.
Jakeem Harris with good coverage. North Carolina State decides to bring a pressure. We're coming after him. You see inside. Here comes the pressure. Wake Forest does a good job of picking it up. The ball outside of the framework of A.T. Perry. As you see Harris just right there. Interesting kind of sequence of events to on third and seven have the design quarterback run that leads to a fourth and five. Mm-hmm. But obviously Dave Clawson, having given up 45 points so far in this football game, did not trust his defense enough at that point to be able to get a stop.
So 4:18 to go. NC State here at home in their opener on top by three. And Houston trying to run the ball, but no place to run there. Taken down by Miles Fox, the defensive tackle. Again, NC State has lost three in a row in this series to Wake Forest. Tonight would have marked their opener against Virginia Tech. But the Wolfpack had to pause practices in August and rescheduled that game to September 26th. They technically had three different opening opponents, Dave Doran said.
You think about how hard that is to prepare for. You're getting ready for an opponent and then it changes. And you know, obviously teams run different offenses, have different personnel. And it's Wolfpack team ready to play tonight, though.
Second down, 11. And on the spin, they take down the running back, Houston. That was Fox again. And that running clock now down to 3:15. Third down and 12.
And I think here on you know, third down here, if you get a stop at this point, I think you do have to start using your timeouts if you're Dave Clawson.
Surprised he didn't take one here?
Well, listen, in college football, when it's, you know, the clock stops when you get a first down, the tempo that their offense operates with, I do understand it, I guess, at this point.
Out of the shotgun. Hockman trying to tiptoe. He's going to be tied up and taken down again. That time, Bailey Hockman had nowhere to go.
And now you have to use it.
2:32 to go.
Fourth
45-42. It's been an immensely entertaining game between NC State and Wake Forest. If Wake falls here tonight, they drop to 0-2. In recent years under Dave Clawson, they've gotten off to very impressive starts, very quick starts, and kind of faded at the end. Now look at a tough schedule here for Wake now, because you've got Notre Dame coming up. You have Virginia on the schedule. You got North Carolina at North Carolina. The good news is here, and you know, closing out with a very good Miami team, who was impressive again tonight. Good news is they only leave North Carolina, the state, one time,
which is incredible and obviously very different than it typically is. But you're right. I mean, it's, you know, obviously that's a tough opener at Clemson. So much speed and so many new players, especially on the offensive side of the ball. And you know, and then Notre Dame right around the corner. It speaks to the volume of importance of this game.
NC State punting away. And Morin with the fair catch. So it falls onto the shoulders of the sophomore Sam Hartman with 2 minutes and 25 seconds to go. He is 21 for 32, 217 yards and a touchdown. His running back, his primary guy tonight has been Kenneth Walker, and he has carried a lot of the weight in this one. But Wake has come up just short to this point. First and 10 for Hartman and the Demon Deacons.
This is a great opportunity for Sam Hartman. Two timeouts, over 2 minutes left. Well, you've moved the ball well all night, and you know, an opportunity to kind of show yourself as a passer.
He was 11 for 21 against Clemson with 182 yards, but always tough to read that. He's back to throw, and he rifles that one. That catch is made and shoved out of bounds. A.T. Perry, who's been one of his favorite targets tonight, that'll gain 8 yards.
It looked like the official signaled to run the clock, which he did, which is, I'm not sure why, with A.T. Perry going out of bounds, but that clock is running.
Yeah, he did go out. And a handoff once again for Walker, trying to bounce outside on that edge, but they tie him up again.
And if you wait with the clock stopped, you need to get this playoff before, you know, before you kind of have to, you know, line up at the line of scrimmage. Clock is stopped, be set. Too much running around in the backfield.
First and 10 for Wake Forest. Hartman back, looking to throw. Gets it off as he's being tackled. And an outstanding effort there by Chapman to try and make the play. Just got rid of it and did well to do that.
Yeah, which he needed to do. It's just a three-man rush. He's holding on to the football. As Joseph is grabbing the back of his jersey, he does a good job of getting it away. Obviously stops the clock.
Second down, 10. Walker again with him in the backfield. Wants to put it in the air. Throwing again and complete. Brewer will make the catch, his first of the ball game.
And that ability to fight for the first down again will get you the first down, stops the clock, which is a big deal considering you were in bounds.
Minute 38 to play. Hartman rolling, leaving the pocket here, and he's going to scamper out of bounds and stop the clock at 1:32. NC State clinging to a three-point lead here in the ACC tonight, 45-42.
And typically when defenses are tired in two-minute drive situations, think about it, NC State has defended 82 plays tonight. You know, that should help eliminate a pass rush, give the quarterback time in this environment to throw the football.
Second down and 6. Pressure, and it pops free. And NC State trying for everybody diving for it as it squirts out of bounds. Boy, it was there for the taking for the Wolfpack, but they could not come up with a fumble.
Sure was. It's great pressure around the edge as Levi Jones just continues to pursue the quarterback. Ball comes out. But watch Kenneth Walker, maybe the play of the night so far, as he dives for this football, kind of knocks it out of bounds. You see Dave Clawson put his arms up in the air, meaning, hey, we still have possession, still have a shot at this.
Makes it third down and 15 with a minute 24 on the clock. More pressure. And this time, he goes down. Joseph in there. Daniel Joseph, who's made some giant plays tonight, the grad transfer from Penn State with the sack.
He really has. This is a program that has had tremendous defensive linemen.
Wake Forest, their second of the half. This will be a 30-second timeout.
It's a program that has had great defensive linemen and guys that could close out football games, and that's what you're getting right now from the guys up front. That's Booker Brown, the true freshman, with a nice spin move, and it's Daniel Joseph, who, as you said, we've called his name a few times tonight, putting pressure on Sam Hartman.
NC State with his sixth sack of the football game. Joseph was originally recruited by Dave Doran 4 years ago. He elected to go to Penn State. He finally gets him back. He appeared in 32 games for the Nittany Lions, now at the Wolfpack, and comes up with the biggest defensive play of the game so far. To make it fourth down and 21, pushing back the Demon Deacons.
Because of the struggles they've had protecting the quarterback, I think in a long developing play, you might need to move the pocket.
Going to have to throw it. He fires, and that one is broken up by the Wolfpack with a minute 10 to go. So NC State scoring 45 points tonight. So much talk about their offense and about their quarterbacks coming into the ball game. Bailey Hawkman taking over as the quarterback for Dave Doran. And everybody thought it was going to be Devin Leary. And yet, in the end, it's defense that locks up the game, perhaps.
It is defense that locks up the game. Well, the story probably wasn't as much the quarterback as it was the run game and the creativity on offense. But the quarterback play, the run game, the defense feels like a team effort. You know, by this NC State group that definitely had seen its fair share of adversity throughout training camp heading into this season, and this one's going to feel pretty good for the Wolfpack.
Well, NC State had to wait so long. He's going to take a knee here. Had to wait so long just to play, Tim, just to get on the field. And Dave Doran talked about this for many weeks. I mean, how good it was going to feel to get together and be a team again and finally face somebody else. And you know, tonight, they have played a really, really wonderful game.
They really have. And you know, they did rally around their quarterback. I mean, rushed for nearly 50 yards, threw for nearly 300. And it was just really impressive effort by Bailey Hawkman, and I think by the group in general. I mean, we focus so much on Devin Leary, you know, kind of not being part of the quarterback competition because of the time he missed. But you know, that I think that they had plenty of guys miss outside of just the quarterback position on both sides of the ball. And so to have this team as ready as they were tonight, I think you have to tip your hat to Tim Beck, the offensive coordinator, Dave Doran, and the rest of this coaching staff.
Well, Dave Doran said that he had been trying to hire Tim Beck for a long time. He said, I couldn't hire him away from anybody else because he was making too much money in those other places. Well, now he's in Raleigh and helping to hang 45 points on the board in the opener against Wake Forest.
And maybe proving that he was worth it, because this team was not good offensively a year ago with the quarterback. You know, that we saw tonight play extremely well on the roster. And I think there was creativity in terms of what they were doing. It wasn't a vanilla offense. They didn't just keep it simple, but they did play fast. They did have some neat ideas. And that's a big win for a program that has been through a lot.
Well, it sure is. NC State is going to win this one 45-42 as the final seconds tick off here at Carter-Finley Stadium in Raleigh. That snaps a six-game ACC losing streak for NC State. Great win for Dave Doran and his team. Tim, a final thought for you.
I'm really impressed with the job that both of these coaching staffs have done to get their teams ready in this situation. But the job that they did at North Carolina State to get Bailey Hockman ready to play as well as he played tonight. Looks like North Carolina State is already off to a pretty good rebound after a rough season a year ago.
NC State, 49 rushes, 270 yards, and four touchdowns. They certainly won it on the ground, and they won it behind Hockman and some great defense in the end. Coming up next, the huddle, 45-42, NC State, the winner tonight.
Welcome back into the huddle. NC State season debut as they host Wake Forest. Coach Doran looking to put in the past that six-game losing streak that they finished last season with. It was Bailey Hockman getting the start, finding Kerry Angeline. NC State leads 35-21. NC State with the ball again. The lucky lefty Hockman with the pass. It's picked off. Jasir Taylor, 45 yards the other way. In the industry, they call that a pick six. Wake Forest trails 35-28. Demon Deacons with the ball now. Kenneth Walker. A little hezzy. 13 yards for the touchdown. Game tied 35 all. Wake Forest trailing by three. Walker again. Tutty and a celebration. A bounce. Demon Deacons up 42-38. 5 minutes left in the game. Ricky Person. Draw a rush touchdown. Wolfpack up 45-42. Less than 2 minutes left. Final chance for Wake Forest. It's no good. NC State wins 45-42. Katie George with Coach Doran.
Dave, this was obviously a very fast-paced game on both sides. Defenses didn't get a lot of breaks, but it was that unit that decided this game for you. What did you think on their effort on that last drive?
Well, they didn't give up. You know, they made some key plays there, and pass rush got better. Just proud of the guys for their resiliency, and we've been through a lot. It was a heck of a football game. Credit, you know, Wake Forest played their butts off, too. They were down and came back, and just proud of our guys for not flinching, you know, not giving in. It was a fun game. We were very physical. I thought on offense, ran the ball. I thought our backs protected. I thought Bailey did a heck of a job coming in, and it was fun. It was a lot of fun.
Speaking of Bailey, I know it wasn't an ideal situation what went on with the quarterbacks. What did you think of his just overall effort and the poise that he showed after making a mistake?
Yeah, he bounced right back. You know, he showed a lot of guts. He took some big hits, too. You know, I mean, he's a tough kid, and he led our team tonight. Scored 45 points with him out there. I'm proud of him.
I know it's not ideal, only a couple of parents in the stands, but how did it feel just to be back out here and playing in the game?
Well, I'm thankful that our parents were allowed. You know, I think that means the world to our players, and so thankful to Governor Cooper for doing that for us. You know, it took a lot to make it happen. Our parents had to do an organized rally of some sorts, but it meant a lot to have them there, and hopefully we'll have more fans as we move forward.
Thanks for the time. We'll see
you
next week.
All right, go Pack.